People looking for somebody to damn fall out the sky, man.
Huh?
Right, with a big glare and a big great light, man. All right. All right, to come down and prophesy unto you. Right? Go ahead.
And
hey, all the prophets, even David, man. Right? Even all of our forefathers, man. They were what? They were gatherers of sheep. They were, hey, Peter, they were fishermen. And they had a regular job. They was regular men, man. Hey, they weren't men in suit and ties, man.
Right?
Hey, the Lord doesn't use the highly esteemed in the other world, man. All right, give me 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 19. Hey, the Lord takes the lowly, man.
Right.
Hey, the Lord is dealing with the babies, man. The meek and the humble, man. Go ahead.
God.
And a gatherer of sycamore fruit.
And a what?
And a gatherer of sycamore fruit.
Read.
And the Lord took me as I followed the flock.
And read that again.
And the Lord took me as I followed the flock.
Hey, you think you got all these brothers out here, man?
Right.
Right? Yeah, brothers that was in the strip club.
Right.
Brothers that was on the block, man.
Right.
Right? Brothers was in all manner of wickedness, man. And the Lord gathered us, man. Go ahead.
And the Lord said unto me.
What the Lord say?
Go prophesy.
What the Lord say?
Go prophesy.
What the Lord say?
Go prophesy.
And the Lord say, go prophesy, man. Go ahead.
Unto my people Israel.
Unto who?
Unto my people Israel.
So everybody want to know why we come out to the highways and the byways, man. Hey, the Lord told us to get up and go prophesy unto the children of Israel.
Right.
Right? Give me the book of Ezekiel chapter 3 and verse 11.
Come on, 1 Corinthians 3 and 19.
Yeah.
Come on, the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 19.
Right.
For the wise like it. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with your house.
What the Lord say?
For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with your house.
Because the Lord said the wisdom of this world is foolishness, man. Right? It's unprofitable, man. The wisdom of this world is going to get you put to death in these last days, man. You got a lot of people with a lot of wisdom. It's much wisdom in the world. But there's also wisdom that's foolish. Right? The only profitable wisdom is thus saith the Lord, man.
That's right.
All right? If it's not coming out of the mouth of the Most High God in the name of his son, it's foolishness, man. Go ahead.
For it is
written. And you know, to sum it up, that's Christianity. Right? Christianity and all this other wine and madness in the world, man. Go ahead.
For it is written, he taketh the wise in their own craftiness.
Right? You can rest right there.
Come.
Bring this out. What else I've called?
Ezekiel
3 and 11?
Yeah, 3 and 11. Book of Ezekiel, chapter 3, verse 11.
Bring it out.
And go, get thee to them of the captivity.
Jeremiah
3 unto the children of thy people.
Unto what?
Unto the children of thy people.
Right? And hey. They talking to Zoe right here? Hey, get Zoe.
Zoe.
Zoe. Zoe. Zoe.
Hey. Hey, you can bring them up here. Y'all got a minute? You got this whole squad, man.
Yeah, come.
Bring it up.
Book of Ezekiel, chapter 3, verse 11.
Bring it out.
And go, get thee to them of the captivity.
The Lord said, go get thee them of the captivity, man. And you got the children of the Most High God in captivity to this day, man. And the Lord told us to come to these people, man. Who are these people, man? These people, they don't know who they are, man. So the Lord has to send forth servants and prophets, messengers, to these people, all right? To break down the scriptures to them, man. To reveal these things unto them. To stir up their memory through the spirit, man. Go ahead.
Unto the children of thy people.
Uh-huh.
And speak unto them, and tell them, thus said the Lord Yahweh.
And do what?
Thus said the Lord Yahweh.
Now tell them something sweet.
Thus said the Lord Yahweh.
Tell them what they want to hear, man.
Thus said the Lord Yahweh.
Hey, tell them, thus said the Most High God, man. Go ahead.
Whether they will hear, or whether they will forbear.
It doesn't matter if they're willing to listen or not. We still got to come out here, lift up our voice like trumpets, all right, and proclaim the word of the Lord.
That's right.
That's how you magnify the name of the Lord, man. All right, through his word, man. Right? Bring this up.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 3 and verse 15.
Bring it up.
And I will give you pastors according to my own heart.
Right.
Which shall feed you the knowledge. Feed you with knowledge and understanding.
With what?
With knowledge and understanding.
So our job is to come and feed the people. Not just go to the people. You can go to a lot of people go to the people, man. Or you got a lot of people that got this book in their hands, man. And they go to the people, man. But they don't give them knowledge. They don't give them wisdom and understanding, man. A lot of we had a Christian couple up here last night, man. They had no understanding of the Bible, man. He told me a lot of stuff that we was taught in church. But we went in the Bible, man, and it got bad. Right? It got real bad, man. Right? So this is our job, man, to make it, to write the vision. Give me that in Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 2. Go ahead.
Book of Luke chapter 4 verse 18.
Bring it out.
The Spirit of the
hold
Lord.
On, hold on, let me get this first.
The book of Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 2.
Bring it out.
Before the decree breaks forth.
Before the destruction come, right? Before all these things happen that we keep warning the people. We come out here week in and week out and we say the same thing. We let you know America's gonna be destroyed. We let you know if you don't repent, you're gonna die in America. All right? We let you know who the children of God are and what they must do. How they must separate from the enemies, man.
Right?
Come out of America, man. And return unto the living God. Go
ahead. That's right. Before the day pass as the chaff, before the fierce anger of the Lord come upon you. Before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you.
Right?
Seek ye the Lord.
Do what?
Seek ye the Lord.
What God say?
Seek ye the Lord.
Read.
All ye meek of the earth.
All ye, and only the meek of the earth is gonna seek the Lord. Man, everybody else is seeking the world, man. Everybody wants to be famous. Everybody wanna look cute. Hey, well, guess what? It's famine coming. Destruction is coming. All the stores gonna be shut down, man. There's not gonna be no such thing as currency, right? There's not gonna be no weave salon stores. Right, you're not gonna go buy no eyelashes. You're not gonna be able to do these things. What are you gonna do in that day? That's why you're supposed to seek the Lord now. Give me Isaiah 55 and verse 6. Go ahead.
Which have wrought his judgment.
Which have what?
Which have wrought his judgment.
Which have hated his judgments. Read.
Seek righteousness.
Do what?
Seek righteousness.
Nobody is seeking righteousness, man. Everybody's going about their own righteousness. All right, nobody, and Christians don't believe in the Bible.
That's right.
And we know this, because we was all once Christians. They don't believe in the Bible. Right? Because they get mad when we come out here and read the words of God. Because it don't sound like your pastor. Right, because he's trained. There's certain scriptures he can't read. Right? And well, we can read everything. We read the whole Bible.
That's right.
Go ahead.
Seek meekness. It's like it. It may be, ye shall be hid. In the day of the Lord's anger.
It may be that what?
That ye may be hid in the day of the Lord's anger.
Because in the day of the Lord's anger, you're not going to be able to escape. There's not going to be no escape. But the meek, the righteous, the elect, the Lord is going to hide you. Meaning the Lord is going to save you and deliver you.
That's right.
Everybody's not going to be saved, man. Just because you say you believe in Jesus, that's not going to save you. That is the biggest lie ever in history. That if I just believe on white Jesus, I'm saved. You got people think they saved right now. Here it is, you gotta pay rent, right? You gotta pay gas. You getting shot in the streets, but you saved. What are you saved from? Go ahead. What's up?
God.
That was my
book of Isaiah, chapter 55, verse 6.
Bring it up.
Seek ye the Lord while he may be found.
What the Lord say?
Seek ye the Lord while he may be found.
Why is the Lord saying, seek me now while you're able to find him? How do you know now is the time to seek the Lord? Because the prophets are back. The truth is out. Wisdom and knowledge is increasing. Give me the book of Daniel chapter 12 and I believe I want verse 4. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Go ahead.
Call ye upon him while he is near.
Call upon the name of the Lord while he's near. Right? While he have his men. Because we're not going to be out here forever. All right, everybody that hate us and walk by us and say them niggas need to shut up. Right? My pastor told me this. Right? Hey, the Lord say, now is the time to seek the Most High God. Now is the time to ask your questions. And get your answers out the Bible. Because the days are coming, you're not going to be able to find the Lord because he's going to hide himself. When the missiles drop, the Lord is not going to be able to be found. The elect are going to be, those that are going to be saved, they're already sealed at that point. Read.
Let the wicked forsake his way.
Let the wicked forsake his way. Go ahead.
And the unrighteous man his thoughts.
And the unrighteous man his thoughts. Read.
And let him return unto the Lord.
And let him do what?
And let him return unto the Lord.
And let him return unto the Most High God. Our people are moving further and further away from the Lord. Right? Hey, we trying to bring you in and draw you to the Lord, man. Give me Luke chapter 14 and 23. Yeah.
And he will have mercy upon him.
And he will do what?
And he will have mercy upon him.
And he will have mercy upon you, man. Because that's what we need. We need mercy, man. All right? That's what we're waiting for. That's what Christ came to do. Right? Yahweh Shai came to bring mercy and grace. Right? Not an excuse to sin even more and be more wicked than your forefather. Because that's what Christianity teach. Christianity teaches, say I believe and I can do anything. Right? I can do all things through Christ except keep the commandments. Because nobody can keep the law. Let's throw away the law. Right? Ain't that right, sis? You a Christian? You a Christian? Huh? You believe in God? You believe in the Bible, sis? I got a question for you. You can come up here. We your brothers. We love you. We're not gonna hurt you. Huh? Go ahead. What's your ethnicity?
What's your nationality?
What's your nationality, sister? What is our race? Who are we? African American, right? When did we become African American? You don't know, in the 1980s, right? Africa is two continents. I mean, Africa and America is two different continents, right? Yeah, turn this around. So look, America, this land that you're standing on right now, this always wasn't America, right? You had people dwelling in this land before the so-called white man got off the nasty boat.
Right?
You had Native American Seminole Indians dwelling in this land. At that point, it wasn't called America. Give me Psalms 49 and 11. Right? So what happened? We're going to read the Bible real quick, all right? Read this.
Book of Psalms, chapter 49, verse 11.
Hey, this is a prophecy of things that were going to happen. This is how we know the Bible is a true book. Read.
Their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever, and their dwelling places to all generations.
Read.
They call their lands after their own name.
They do what?
They call their lands after their own name.
The Bible said they were going to call their lands after their own names, right? Like America. America is named after a so-called white man named Amerigo Vespucci, right? Africa also is named after a Roman emperor. You listening, sis? A Roman emperor named Scipio Africanus, right? So when we call ourselves African-American, we calling ourselves after the name of two so-called white men.
That's right.
Because Africa's not in the Bible and America's not in the Bible. That's actually confusion. That's why when we got off the slave ships, they didn't call us African. Because they know you not no African. Right? You're an Israelite, sister.
Right.
We are actually God's chosen people.
That's right.
Right? And we can prove that to you out of the Bible. How do we get to America? You know? You remember? How we got to this side of the world? You ever heard of slavery? You heard about slavery, right? And they brought us over here by what mode of transportation? Yeah, on slave ships, right? And they make many movies about it. So give me the book of Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1. Huh. Read that first, Isaiah 1.
Okay. Look at Isaiah chapter 1 verse 3.
Bring it out.
The ox knows his owner and the ass his master's crib.
So the Lord said, an ox know who he belongs to and a jackass he can find his way home, right? Go ahead.
But Israel does not know.
So the Lord said an ox and a jackass is smarter than us. We don't know who we are. We'll call ourselves whatever we're told. Some of our people say they black. And you got on a black shirt, right? Some of our people call themselves African American. These are names that was given to us by the same people that raped, robbed, pillaged, and murdered us. Right? If they said that we were blue people, we'd be calling ourselves blue today. Right? Read.
My people does not consider.
God has a chosen people, and he's saying his people, they don't consider these things. They don't care who they are, right? They'll call themselves two continents with great confidence. I'm African and I'm American, right? That's not possible. So let's find out who we really are. Give me the book of Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1.
Come, the book of Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1.
Yeah.
These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
You heard of the prophet Moses, right, sis? In the Bible, Moses? Well, Moses is the man that the Most High sent to deliver the children of Israel out of slavery and bondage in Egypt. It was in slavery under King Pharaoh, right? So the Lord, in the book of Deuteronomy, is speaking to these people, the children of Israel, all right? Give me Deuteronomy 28 and 15.
Come. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So the Lord told these people, if they don't listen to him, because he made a covenant with them. He gave us laws, statutes, and commandments, all right? And he said, if we don't listen to him, go ahead.
To observe, to do all his commandments.
If we don't do all his commandments, read.
And his statutes, which I command you this day, that all these curses.
All these curses, all these punishments and judgments, read.
Shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
The Lord said, this is a marker on a certain people to identify who they are. The curses, right? Out of all the nations of people on the earth, would you say that's one particular nation that's in a worse condition compared to all the other people? Right. That's plain, right? So let's read.
Cursed shall thou be in the city.
The Lord said the Israelites will be cursed in the cities. You listen? You following me, sis? You following me? What we just read?
Exactly.
Hey, sister, this is a matter of life and death. Right? Hey, this life is not a game.
Done.
And it's important to know who you are, sis. We out here for you. Right? So God said his chosen people will be cursed in the cities. Right? Like, who's cursed in the city of America? Black people, right? Read.
And cursed shall thou be in the field.
Right? We was cursed in his slave fields. We were cursed in their cotton fields, tobacco fields, sugarcane fields. Right? We cursed in the work field today. We last hired, first fired. Right? Y'all would agree to that, right?
I would.
All right.
It's terrible. It's terrible. But you know what I mean? It's terrible. It's terrible, man.
Go ahead.
32. Verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
What the Lord say?
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
See that, man? Give me the book. Give me Zechariah 7 and 11. See that, man? Hey, she rather be an African American, man, than learn the truth. Right?
The book of Zechariah.
Hey, our people rather believe a lie. Hey, the lie is it feels better, man. Give me Jeremiah 8 and 3. Right? Hey, decisions are being made every day, man, through the Spirit. Go ahead.
The book of Zechariah, chapter 7 and verse 11.
Read.
But they refuse to hearken.
What the Lord say?
But they refuse to hearken.
What's our sister's problem?
But they refuse to hearken.
Hey, she refused to listen. Hey, the Most High Power sent her up here and gave her a wonderful opportunity.
Come.
All right? To ask any question, to learn all the mysteries and the secrets, all right? To learn how to get the kingdom of heaven, man. To learn what the Lord requires of her, man. To learn why she's in that condition, why she have on tight booty shorts, man, walking with her daughter, right? Read.
And pulled away the shoulder.
What did she do?
And pulled away the shoulder.
Hey, Satan kind of grabbed her and said, it's time to go.
Come.
Before he get any deeper, before you learn the truth and you get sealed, we got to get you out of here, man.
Come.
And she said, well, let's go, Satan. I'm rolling with you, right? Go ahead.
And stop the ear.
What did she do?
And stop the ear.
She stopped her ears, man. It was about to get good, man. It was just getting started, man. Go ahead.
That they should not hear.
That what?
That they should not hear.
That she should not hear. She didn't want to hear. She didn't want it, man. Hey, the Lord never said every Israelite had to hear the entire breakdown.
Come.
We had to go all the way through Deuteronomy 28, right? Go to verse 16 and read every curse all the way through 68.
Come.
Right? Hey, the Lord is marking those that reject the word too.
That's right.
Hey, the Lord said the gospel had to be taught throughout all the world and then the end shall come.
God.
Right? So you got some people, they can refuse to listen. That don't mean they got to hear the whole thing.
God.
You right? Go ahead.
Yay, they made their heart as hearts like it. Yay, they made their hearts as an adamant stone.
And that's what she did. She made her mind an adamant stone. Our people's head is harder than a rock.
God.
Go ahead.
At least they should hear the law.
Because what? We was gonna go into the law.
Come.
If she would have stayed long enough, she'd have found out she can't dress like that.
Come.
She'd have found out she had to keep the Sabbath day.
Come.
Meaning what? She would have figured out that she gotta change.
That's right.
And our people don't wanna change, man. That's the problem. It's easy to be a Christian because you don't have to change anything. You can do a lot of talking.
Come.
All you gotta do is say what you believe.
Right.
Hey, well, the Lord is a God of knowledge and actions are weighed, man.
Come.
Right? Go ahead.
Come.
Jeremiah.
And the words which the Lord of hosts had sent in his spirit by the former prophet.
By the what?
By the former prophet.
By the nasty pastors today.
By the former prophet.
So the Lord sent you before the servants of the Lord, man. This is the word that he sent by the former prophet. That's why we don't need a damn script and we don't got a damn preacher's prosperity doctrine to get you to come and listen, right? All we got to do is open the Bible and tell you the same thing that was written of old, man. It still stands today because this word is alive. Hey, we serve the living God, man.
Right.
That's it on that. Bring this out.
Book of Jeremiah chapter 8, verse 3.
Bring it out.
And death shall be chosen rather than life.
Give me the book of Deuteronomy 11 and 26. What the Lord say?
And death shall be chosen rather than life.
And people out here choosing death, man. You literally got the Lord, through the Spirit, setting people up to make a decision to choose life or to choose death. And you got people, and this is talking about Israelites.
That's right.
All right? When you read the book of Jeremiah, it's not talking about the other nations. Their judgment is set in stone. They have judgments that are written. Read Jeremiah 47, read Jeremiah 48, read Jeremiah 49. Those are the judgments that the nations have to serve. You have Israelites through the Lord who died for you, man. All right? The precious Lamb of God, man. Who gave his life to give you an opportunity to choose life, man. To repent, man. But yet you got people rejecting the Messiah. And when you reject the truth of the Bible, you rejecting the Lord, man. You rejecting Yahushua, right? And they're choosing death, man, rather than live. You know why? Because they don't believe, man. Read.
And death shall be chosen rather than life by all the residue of them that remain of this evil family.
By all the residue of them that remain of this evil family. Because we was once a part of the evil family. But you got a residue of our people. They want to stay there, man. They like this place, man. Right? She don't want to be reminded of the atrocities and the pain and the rape, rob, and murder of her forefathers, right? She want to sweep it under the rug and keep it pushing, man, like everything is all good in America, right? Bring this out, man.
Which remain in all the places whither I have driven them, saith the Lord of hosts.
Right, give me, now give me the book of Luke chapter 4 and verse 18.
You still want Deuteronomy?
Yeah, get this first. Like,
the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 11, at verse 26, behold, I set before you this day a blessing and a curse.
What the Lord say?
A blessing and a curse.
Hey, the Lord set before us blessing and curses, man. That's important to know that. Before you go into the New Testament, it's important to know these things. So you have to read the history. The Lord set before you blessing and curses. Read.
A blessing if ye obey the commandments of the Lord your God.
Hey, a blessing. Give me the book of Revelation chapter 22 and verse 14. All right, a blessing if you obey the voice of the Lord, man. Read.
Which I command you this day.
Right.
And a curse.
And a what?
And a curse.
And a curse, read.
If ye will obey not the commandments of the Lord your God.
If you don't obey the commandments of the Lord thy God. We were going to show the sister that the Lord, he done came through on all his promises and all his judgments, man. Everything the Lord said was going to happen to us, happened to us. All right, so when the Lord said he's going to deliver you and save you, he's going to do that too, right? But you also, read this real quick.
Book of Revelation chapter 22, verse 14.
Because everybody want to make it to the kingdom of heaven. Everybody wants sweet Jesus to save them, right? Everybody's blessed and highly favored today, man. They got the damn mugs, they got the t-shirts, they got the license plates, right? Blessed, I'm blessed and highly favored, man. Right? But you eat pork every morning, right? But you blessed and highly favored. The Lord favors you, right? Read that.
Blessed are they that do his commandments.
What the Lord say?
Blessed are they that do his commandments.
And the Lord say, you only blessed if you keep the commandments.
Right.
Right? Read.
That they may have right to the tree of life.
That they may what?
Have right.
May have the right to the tree of life.
That they may have right to the tree of life. Read.
And may enter in through the gates into the city.
And may enter into the kingdom of heaven, into the gates, man. You got to do the commandment. Give me the book of Luke chapter. Give me Acts 3 and 19. Give me Luke 10, 25. Acts.
The book of Acts.
Rest. You ain't got to get that.
10, 25?
Yeah.
Book of Luke chapter 10, verse 25.
Bring it out.
And behold, a certain lawyer stood up and tempted him, saying, Master, what shall I do to inherit eternal life?
To do what?
To inherit eternal life.
How do you get the kingdom of heaven, man? How do you get delivered out of this fire and the death and the destruction and the famine and all manner of evil that's getting ready to happen in the earth? Go ahead.
He said to him, What is written in the law?
What is what?
What is written in the law?
No, just believe on me.
What is written in the law?
What is written in the law? So what do you got to do? What good things to do? You got to do the things that are written in the law.
God.
Right? You got to keep the commandments of the Most High God, man, to get the kingdom of heaven, man. That's why the Lord, give me the classic, get Isaiah 58 and 1. All right, that's why we come out here to teach our people, all right? Teach our people that, you got it? Bring it out.
The book of Isaiah chapter 58 and verse 1. Cry out loud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people that transgression.
What do we have to do?
And show my people that transgression.
Nobody want nobody to show them their sins. Right? Our job is to show you your transgression, to show you where you're going off at.
Huh.
Right? To correct you, man. That's love. Hey, brother, you got a minute?
2 minutes, bro.
Give me 2 minutes, brother.
Okay. Yeah, you.
Hey, I got a question for you, bro. Give me 2 minutes, brother. Go ahead.
And the house of Jacob, their sins.
And the what?
And the house of Jacob, their sins.
And the house of Jacob, their sins. Man, that's our job, man. Why? Give me that. Bring that up. Acts 3, 3 and 19.
The book of Acts, chapter 3 and verse 19. Repent ye therefore and be converted.
Because we have to repent and change. We have to change from our wicked ways, man. Go ahead.
That your sins may be blotted out.
That what?
That your sins may be blotted out.
Because this is a sinful kingdom, man. You living in the evilest place ever made, man. The evilest kingdom that the Lord set up, man. Right? And before the Lord comes, give me the book of Revelations. Before the Lord comes and judge this earth, right? You don't want to get caught up in the sins of this place, man. The sins of America, man. All right, that's what our people are indulging in, man. That's why our people don't want to come and hear the word, man. Bring it up.
Done.
What do you want to count?
18? That your sins may be blotted out.
Uh-huh.
When the time of refreshing shall come.
When the what?
When the time of refreshing shall come.
When the time of refreshing shall come, man. Right? That's when the destruction comes.
Come.
Right? When the Lord come and purify and cleanse the earth again like he did in the times past.
Come.
Right? Go ahead.
From the presence of the Lord.
From the presence of the Lord. Bring it up.
18 to 4.
Down. Book of Revelation chapter 18 verse 4.
Bring it out.
And I heard another voice from heaven say.
Start at verse 2.
Verse
now read 4 and then jump up to 2.
And I heard another voice from heaven say, come out of her, my people.
What the Lord say?
Come out of her, my people.
And the Lord said to come out of this place. Separate.
Come.
All right. Flee. Flee these times, man.
Right.
All right. That's what the sister don't understand, man. All right. She left the truth. All right, to go into the world, man, instead of coming out of the world. Some of our people like this place, man. Some of our people hate it here. Some of our people, you got people on the earth that's waiting for the Most High. They waiting on the Lord to come save them. You got men, women, and children that's waiting on salvation. And you have men, women, and children, they done moved in, man. Right? Like I always say, man, hey, you got people that go to prison, all right, and they looking to get out, man. They watching the calendar. Cause this all America is a prison cell.
That's right.
Right? This is Egypt. All right? This is captivity. Right? You got them in there, they watching the damn calendar, counting down the days, waiting to get out. And then you got some of our people, man, hey, they don't want to leave prison. Hey, that happens, man.
Try to be the big man.
Yeah, and they been in prison, so they kind of got a name. They kind of run into prison. They don't want to leave, man. Right. Ain't no place to say, mama, I ain't, you know, I ain't the same. Yeah. They done got conformed to the prison life. So they don't want to leave. That's us in America. Here it is, the Lord getting ready to release you from the prison, and you don't want to leave. You want to stay here. This is what we're dealing with. Go ahead.
That ye be not partakers of her sin.
That what?
That ye be not partakers of her sin.
Hey, because the Lord didn't bring you here to assimilate. The Lord didn't bring you on slave ships in America to get down with America and become a damn American, man.
That's right.
All right? To become a damn chocolate covered Edomite, man.
Right.
That's what I see, man, with our people, man.
Come.
Go ahead. These are Gentiles, man. All right, these are the Gentiles in the New Testament. Like that sister. Go ahead.
And that ye, and that ye receive not of her plague.
Man, he got to send him up here.
And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the great is fallen.
What the Lord say?
Babylon the great is fallen.
Read.
It's fallen. And it's become the habitation of devils.
And the Lord said, this is where devils dwell, man.
Right.
In America, this is where wickedness is. Right? Hey, sis, what's your nationality?
Me?
Yeah.
What?
What's your ethnicity?
What's your nationality?
What's your race?
American.
Black folks, just like y'all.
Right. What?
Come on.
Hey, what color is your shirt? What color is your shirt?
Oh, it's just something.
Get you out.
What color is your shirt?
What color is your pants?
Black.
So are you the same color as your...
Now, I'm gonna identify with that word black. Definitely. I like it. I'm gonna represent black 24/7.
But you're not black though.
Now I know you might say I'm pecan tan or something like that, but I'm just a whole country black man.
Come up here, I wanna talk to you. Come up here and talk to me, brother. Give me Jeremiah 4:22.
The book of Jeremiah.
This man.
My people is foolish.
What the Lord say?
My people is foolish.
What's the brother that love black?
My people is foolish.
See, I'm just a black man in America trying to make it. My brother, you're not going to make it like that.
Right.
That's right. Right? Jake Steady trying to make it. We never going to make it here.
Kai.
This place was set up again. You can't make it in America. The American dream is a lie, man.
That's right.
Not real, man. That's why he's 59 still trying to make it, man. With damn Nickelodeon on his sweater, man. It's complete madness, man. The Lord said we foolish, Reed.
They have not known me.
They what?
They have not known me.
And this is why, because we don't know the Lord, man. This is what happens when you separate from your God, man.
Done.
Go ahead.
They are sadist children.
They are what?
They are sadist children.
They are stupid as hell, man. Our people are slow, man. You can't even have an intelligent conversation, man, with an elder brother, man. Right? That man said this is the stupidest stuff I ever heard in my life, and then he got out of here. I wanted to give him a chance to redeem himself, man. Right? Go ahead.
They have none understanding.
They have none understanding, man. He can't even understand what he was talking about, man.
None.
Right? And the Lord sent us out here to give you the understanding, man. All right, but what our people do? They reject it. Go ahead.
They are wise to do evil.
Right.
But to do good, they have no knowledge.
Our people have no knowledge of how to do good according to the Most High God, according to the Bible. Right? But our people are wise to do evil, man.
Huh.
I guarantee you, 9 times out of 10, they get ready to do some evil, man. 90% of the time, when you don't follow the Bible and you're not in the spirit of the Lord, you're doing evil, man.
Huh.
Right? Bring this up.
Back to 18:2.
God.
Book of Revelation, chapter 18, verse 2.
And this is why we got to get the hell out of America. Go ahead.
And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the Great is falling.
What the Lord say?
Babylon the Great is falling.
So here it is, America is falling, right? Go ahead.
It's falling, and it's become the habitation of devils.
And it's become the habitation of devils.
Huh.
Right? Why would you want to live and dwell where devils reside? Why would you want to move in, right, and get a damn room in the devil's house?
Right.
Go ahead. Hey, Miguel, you got somebody, they damn looking out the window, man. They watching for the return of the Lord, man. You know, like you get when you was young, man.
Huh.
And you down, you get dropped off at that auntie house you hate going over.
Yeah.
Right? They don't got no cable. They got roaches. Ain't never got no food at home.
Yeah.
You know that one auntie house you don't want to be over there, man. And you just looking out the window waiting on your mama to come.
Yep.
You cry. Right? That's how we are in America, man.
Huh.
You don't want to be here, man.
Huh.
Go ahead.
And the whole of every foul spirit.
And America is the hold of every foul spirit. Every foul demon spirit that you read about in the Bible, the Lord say they all in America, man.
Come
on. Go ahead.
And a cage of every unclean and hateful bird.
And a cage of every unclean and hateful bird, man. Come
on.
Right? So we got to separate and get the hell. Give me the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 6 and 17. Yeah. 2 Corinthians 6 and 17. Starting at 14. Now you got it.
Verse 3. For all nations have drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornication, and the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her.
That's it on that. Give me Psalms 104 and 36. 30, 35.
Come on. The book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 6, and 14.
Right?
Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers.
Right.
For what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness?
Right. The Lord said, don't be unequally yoked together with unbelievers, man. Uh-huh. Right? Why is our people intermeddling in the world? You got people that, I know people that's Christians, they deal with people that don't even believe in the Bible. So they don't even follow Paul, man. And Paul is that top guy, man. The Lord said, don't be unequally yoked together with non-believers, man. Go ahead.
For what?
And Christianity think you're just supposed to love every damn thing.
Done.
Right? Go ahead. Hey, the Lord tell you some things to abstain from. Give me 1 Thessalonians 5:22. Go ahead.
Come. For what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness?
How can you fellowship with unrighteousness? How do you have homosexuals in the church building, man? How do you have homosexual pastors? How are you fellowshipping with unrighteousness and nobody's rebuking and correcting them? Right? Hey, the Christian church is a hold of every hateful bird and unclean thing, man. All right, because they hate each other, because they scared to correct and rebuke each other, man. Right, go ahead, that everything gonna be all right spirit. Go ahead.
And what communication, slug it, and what communion hath light with darkness?
And what communion have light with darkness? We talked about that last night.
Come.
Right, hey, the Lord divided. Give me that real quick in Genesis chapter 1 and verse 3. Give me Genesis 1 and 3, man. And we the children of the light. Give me 1 Thessalonians 5:5. Go ahead.
The book of Genesis, chapter 1 and verse 3.
Right.
And the Most High said, let there be light. And there was light.
Right.
And the Most High saw the light, that it was good.
And it was what?
That it was good.
And it was good, read.
And he divided the light from the darkness.
And he did what?
And he divided the light from the darkness.
No, he allowed to be together.
And he did light from the darkness.
And the Lord divided the light from darkness in the beginning, man.
God.
Darkness, it's impossible for darkness and light to dwell together, right? Either it's dark, if you cut the light on, it's not dark no more, right? Go ahead.
I'm gonna go back to
what you got?
The book of Sirach, chapter 13, verse 17.
Right.
What fellowship hath the wolf with the lamb?
Right.
So the sinner with the godly.
So the what?
So the sinner with the godly.
So the sinner with the godly. Hey, that's plain upon tape. You can't get around that, man. Give me Psalms 105 and 39. Right? Give me Psalms 43 and 3.
You said 35? Wait, you said 104 and 35. That's what you want?
Nah, call it a different one. You can read that too, though.
You want 105?
Right. You can drop that.
Which one?
Read the second one, though.
You said 43 and 3, right?
Yeah, bring this out.
The book of Psalms, chapter 43 and verse 3.
Bring it out.
Oh, send out thy light and thy truth.
Read again.
Oh, send out thy light and thy truth.
Do what?
Oh, send out thy light and thy truth.
And the Lord says, send forth the light and the truth, man. Go ahead.
Let them lead me.
Let them what?
Let them lead me.
Read.
Let them bring me unto the holy hill.
Let them do what?
Let them bring me unto the holy hill.
Hey, we trying to take our hey, brother. Hey, you got a minute, brother? Hey, you got a minute?
2 minutes.
You got a minute?
All praise to the Most High.
All man. Praise.
All praise. Psalms 105 and 39.
Yeah,
finish that. Okay, go ahead.
Come. And to thy tabernacle.
And to thy tabernacle. So our job is to be the light and lead our people out of darkness, man. All right, bring this out.
Book of Psalms, chapter 105, verse 39. He spread a cloud for a covering.
Uh-huh.
And a fire to give light in the night.
And a what?
And a fire to give light in the night.
Go ahead.
The people asked, and he brought quails and
that's it on that. How you doing, bro? What's going on, family? What's your name?
Rick.
My name's Jonathan, man. Nice doing? To meet you, brother.
Likewise.
Right. You believe in the Bible?
I sure do.
All right, all praise. You Christian?
No.
Okay, all praise. So what we out here doing, man, we teaching the truth of the Bible in these last days. Right? We teaching our people the truth of who they are and what they must do in order to obtain salvation. All right, we teach the gospel, the good news, all right, to the children of the Most High God in the last days before death and destruction comes, right? What would you say your ethnicity is or your race?
Black.
Black, right? So look, what color is this vest right here?
It's black.
That's black, right? So can you and this be the same thing?
I'm dark. That's darker.
Shake her head.
Yeah, but. Yeah.
Hey, the little girl, shake her head.
Yeah, I seen it. Yeah, but we're showing you that, yeah, we dark, in terms of tone, but to call ourselves black, that would be not the truth, right? Because I'm looking at the eyebrows are black. If you're gonna call yourself a color, you would be brown, right? Not that we even brown. But when you deal with ethnicity and race, you're dealing with seed line, dealing with a nation of people. And there's no nation of people that's a color in a crayon box. You see what I'm saying? We were called and labeled black, like even in the Bible, right? Like they, what else they call us? Nigger, right? Which means what? Black. They also called us Negro, which means what? Black, right? But are we black? I would be considered black, right? Am I the color of this? No.
No, no.
No. So, right, all of us believe in the Bible, but yet we never read about a nation of people that the Lord called black. But the Lord created 18 nations in the Bible. You have to come from one of these nations in the Bible.
Right.
If the Most High God of the Bible created everybody, right? And the thing that we don't know is who we are in the Bible. Only thing we know is what we were told we were in slavery.
Right.
We only have slave knowledge, right? But now in the last days, the Lord said knowledge shall be increased. And that's what you send before the destruction comes. So the Lord sent us out here to increase our people in knowledge, all right? And give you the truth so you can teach your daughter, all right? And we can get the hell out of America,
right. All right?
So bring this out. Give me the book of Isaiah 1 and 3 real quick.
Book of Isaiah chapter 1, verse 3.
Jeremiah 17 and 4.
The ox knows his owner.
Right, the Lord said the ox know who he belongs to, right? Read.
And the ass is master's crib.
A jackass is a slow animal. He's a dumb animal. A jackass can be dropped off thousands of miles away. He can find his way home.
Right.
Read.
But Israel does not know.
But God's chosen people, they don't know who they are. Read.
My people does not consider.
God said he has a people. And his people, they don't even care who they are anymore. Right? Give me the book of Jeremiah 17 and 4.
The book of Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 4.
Bring it out.
And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thine heritage.
Read.
That I gave
thee. So this is a prophecy. It was prophesied that the children of God would be cut off and discontinued from knowing who they are. Right. In the time that we're living in now.
Right.
In the time of the Bible, he knew who he was. Right. This is the prophet Jeremiah. How is Jeremiah going to not know who he is? This is a future prophecy. This is eschaton. Go ahead.
And I will cause, thee to serve thine enemy.
How is he going to do it? By causing us to serve an enemy. Read.
In a land which thou knowest not.
Meaning what? You will be taken out of your land. You will no longer be in your land. You will be taken into a land that you know it's not. This is the place you will lose everything. Go ahead.
For ye have kindled a fire in my anger.
Because we did something. We kindled a fire against the Most High Power that chose us. Go ahead.
Which shall burn forever.
All right, so now read this. And this is why it's important to know who you are, brother. Because some people may say, I was taught it don't matter.
Come.
Right? Just believe on the Lord and you're going to be saved. All that other stuff don't matter. Right. But that's not the case. Because the Lord is dealing with knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. All right, so read this real quick. Do you believe in Christ?
I believe there's a higher source. There's a higher power.
All right, so you believe. So you don't believe in the Bible? Or you do?
I do.
Okay. So in the Bible, the Lord, the Most High Power, all right, what he does when you read from the beginning until now, he sent forth saviors, like Moses. He sent Moses to do what? Deliver the children of Israel out of slavery under Pharaoh.
Right.
It's prophesied that in the last days, he would send his son, all right, to come and to make war with the earth and deliver those same people again. Okay? So let's see what he said right here. Read this.
Book of Matthew, chapter 15, verse 24.
Bring it out.
But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
So the Messiah said he's only sent. He only came on the scene for the lost sheep of the house of Israel. So you have people on the earth that in the Bible is referred to as lost sheep, right?
Right.
Of all the people on the earth, who will you say the most lost people is?
Our people,
right? Well, this is a reason why the Lord is sent to these people, because they lost, right? Let's rewind and go back and find out what happened and why, all right? Because that's very important. Give me Deuteronomy 1 and 1.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 1.
Bring it up.
These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Now, you're going to figure out there's a common theme in the Bible. You believe in the Bible too, King? All right, and it's a common thing in the Bible. When we read the scriptures, you're going to find out the Lord is talking to Israel the whole time.
Right.
He's not dealing with no other nation.
Sure.
All right? So these are words that Moses is speaking to all the house of Israel. All right? So now let's jump up to Deuteronomy 28 and 15. Brother, how do we get to America? What mode of transportation? How do we end up in America? What would you say, King? Slave ships, all praises, right? Yeah. It's a fact that we came over here on cargo slave ships. You know about that history? All right, why would you say that happened to us? We got all the nations in the world. They could have went and got anybody. Right. Why did they come get us, our people, and scatter us on these slave ships to these different places? You don't know? All right, so we're going to show you why. All right, give me Deuteronomy 28 and 15.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 15.
So this is after Moses split the sea. The Lord delivered us with a mighty hand before all the nations. He destroyed the Egyptians, killed their firstborn sons. He did mighty things for this one people.
Right.
He made a covenant with us. He gave us laws, statutes, and commandments. This is what he telling us. Read that.
28 and 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day.
So this is a father talking to his children. He gave us rules, regulations, laws. He said, look, if y'all don't do what I told you to do, it's going to be consequences. It's going to be judgments and punishments upon you. This is what curses are. In the Bible, when it speaks about curses, these are the judgments of God that he will put on an entire nation of people. Go ahead.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
No, they're going to go away.
That shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Read.
Cursed shall thou be in the city.
And the Lord said the Israelites will be cursed in the city. How we live in the city? How we live? Are we cursed in the city? Are we on top or are we on bottom? Huh? Yeah. That's all. Hey, brother. That's all we talking about up here. All right. So you said what? You would say what?
If it's still like that.
No, I'm talking about right now today. Are we on top or are we on the bottom?
We on the bottom. In this day, without that, we on top.
Wait, hold on. We on top? When the last time you been to the hood? In the ghettos, in the slum? Who lives in these places? Right. So when did we get on top?
Exactly.
Right. All right. Who's the president? Who makes the laws? Who's shooting us in the street? Right. All right. Who lives in the penthouse suites? Right. Who owns the stores that you go spend money? Whose face is on the dollar?
Right.
All right. So again, who's on top and who's on bottom? We on the bottom. Right. So we cursed in the city. Right. We last hired and first fired. Right.
Done.
We're not on top by any means necessary. Go ahead.
And cursed shall thou be in the field.
And cursed shall thou be in the field. Read, 32.
Come, verse 32.
How old are you, King? 20. Okay, you young. So I know by the time your group came up, they ain't teach you none of this, right?
Nah.
Ain't teach you none of this. Nah. So you don't know anything about your foreparents. You don't know why the so-called white man treat us like this, right? So we're gonna take a different approach with you, all right? So we're gonna kind of flip the script a little bit, all right? So now, do you know about slave ships?
Not a lot.
Not a lot, but do you know that's how we came over here? So give me 54.
Come on. The book of Deuteronomy.
What about black on black crime?
Yeah.
Why do we kill each other? Why are there gangs? Why are there Bloods and Crips?
Vice Lord.
Do the Bloods and the Crips, do they go, have you ever seen the Bloods and the Crips go shoot up a white neighborhood? Right? Do they pull up on the police station and make war? What do they go and kill at? People that look like them that's going through the same things as them, right? Why do you think that happens? We're going to show you that that's a curse and a punishment from God. This is how we know we're these people. All right, so read this. Here's one of the curses.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 54.
Bring it out.
So that the man that was, like it, that is tender among you and very delicate.
Because we didn't always used to do that to each other. We used to have love for each other.
Time.
Right? We used to respect each other as men. Read.
And very delicate, his eye shall be evil towards his brother.
His what?
His eye shall be evil towards his brother.
So whoever these people are, the Lord said these people's eyes will be evil toward each other. Right? Like the so-called white man could shoot your mom in the back of the face. All right? Or the back of the head.
Back of the head.
Right? And nobody will do anything. Right?
Fine.
But what happens if little Ray Ray, all right, go shoot Pookie's mom? What's going to happen? What are you going to do?
I'm going to jail for a long time.
Yeah, no, what are you gonna do though? Yeah. Is he gonna retaliate? When a so-called black man do something to another black man, does he retaliate? Yeah. Somebody gonna die.
Huh.
Right? And he might go shoot up his mama house.
Huh.
Right? And that's happening right now today. And they might live on the same block. Right? But the difference is, we don't do that when it comes to the other people.
Huh.
You see what I'm saying? Read it again.
So that the man that is tender among you and very delicate, his eyes shall be evil towards his brother.
Right.
And toward the wife of his bosom, and towards the remnant of his children.
So the Lord said his eye will be evil towards his own brother. Right? So we have an evil eye toward one another because it was written as a punishment for breaking the commandments of God. And toward what?
And towards the wife of his bosom, and towards the remnant of his children, which he shall leave.
Right? So who's known for leaving their children? Right. That's why you got single, independent black women.
Yep.
Where's the single, independent white women at? Where's the strong white woman? You ever heard that before? Strong, independent Chinese woman? Why they don't have to be strong and independent? Because they have their family structure. Right? So these things only fit what people? Black people. Right? Give me 48.
Verse 48. Therefore shall thou serve.
Start at 47.
Verse 47. Because thou servest not the Lord thy God. Because
we don't serve our God. Right? You know who we serve? We serve ourselves.
Huh.
We serve the black woman.
Huh.
Right? We serve white Jesus.
Huh.
Right? We serve Allah. Right? We serve sin. That's who we serve. Satan. Read.
Because thou serve not the Lord thy God with joyfulness of heart. With joyfulness and gladness of heart for abundance of all things. Therefore shall thy serve thine enemy.
So God said, therefore, since we don't serve him with joyfulness and gladness, he's going to make us serve our enemies now. The enemy is another people. So now you got to go serve somebody else.
Jesus.
Go ahead.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
Which what?
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
Which the Lord shall send. The Lord was going to send a people against us. Right? Read.
And hunger.
So you, our people try to figure out why stuff like this happened. Right? You know about this? These are the people that God sent against us. Right? That's why you live in a world where things like this constantly happen. And everybody marching and trying to figure out why. Right? Read.
In hunger.
And what?
In hunger.
And hunger. So when you hungry, brother, you got to serve your enemy. Where you go for food when you hungry? McDonald's, right? Damn. Who owns McDonald's? Yeah. So you go to McDonald's and you pull out that nasty dollar with that white man on it that he gave you, right? When you was working for him, and you got to give it back to him.
Yep.
Right? So he plays football with your money. And he give you a little bit, and he just wait for you to throw it back to him. You see what I'm saying? Go ahead.
And in thirst.
When you thirsty, so you want a Coke, where you gonna go? If you want some lemonade, where you gotta go get it? You gotta go to his stores, right? Read, this is you serving your enemy in thirst, read.
And in nakedness.
Clothes on your back. When you want to, you got about 5 Nike checks, man. One, two, damn. 1, 2, 3, 4. Damn, Nike put 2 of them.
Yeah.
You got the double check, double Nike check, right? Who is Nike? Who owns Nike? Does Michael Jordan own Nike?
Nah.
Huh?
Nah.
Who owns Nike? So you have to buy that, and his family, they get rich.
Huh?
You see what I'm saying? So when you want clothes on your back and nakedness, you gotta serve an enemy. Read.
And in the want of all things.
In the want of all things. So whatever a nigga want, guess what he gotta do?
Huh.
You gotta serve his enemy.
Jesus.
What if we want an education? You in college? You going to college? You graduate college already? What school you go to?
I would.
You went to like a trade school?
No, I went to a music school.
A music school? You went to Full Sail? Okay. What you in, recording engineer? Your producer?
Singer.
Singer? Right? Sing something real quick. Nah.
He won't do it.
Yeah. No folly. All right, you can say that for Sunday morning. All right? So look. The Lord said in one of all things. So when you went to school, what did you learn in school? You know Christopher Columbus? Right? You know Sam Houston? You know George Washington? You know Abraham Lincoln? Right? Mm-hmm. What about King Ahaz? What about Joseph?
Where's Joseph?
Benjamin.
What about Moses?
The Lord?
What? Who?
Like, Lord Moses.
See that, man? What about David? What about Solomon?
Solomon, I know Solomon.
You know Solomon? Who is Solomon?
He was, I know about him, but like not too much.
Not too much.
Yeah.
What about Abraham Lincoln? What you know about Abraham Lincoln?
He freed the slaves.
See that?
I don't know too much. They didn't teach that in school.
You don't learn nothing in school, man.
They didn't allow that.
You were just there.
Yeah, they didn't allow that.
You had to be there. You see what I'm saying? Well, these men are your forefathers.
Con.
These are mighty men in the Bible, man.
Con.
Your history is the Bible, man. They're not white people. All right? Give me verse 68.
Verse 68.
Bring it out.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Uh-huh.
With ships.
So the Lord said, they just delivered the Israelites out of captivity. The Lord said, now I'm going to bring y'all into another slavery. But this time with ships. Right? So we got to prove to you that Egypt means slavery, all right? Bring it up.
Book of Exodus chapter 20, verse 2.
Bring it up.
I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
Out of what?
Out of the house of bondage.
So Egypt is synonymous with slavery or bondage, right? That's why America, we was in the slave fields. We was doing the same thing in America that we did in Egypt.
Right.
Right? Give me Exodus. Give me that Exodus 1 and 11. All right, let's see what these people were doing in Egypt. For God to say, I'm going to bring you into Egypt again. And in Egypt, they walked in Egypt and walked out. You don't need a boat or a ship.
Huh.
All right? Read that.
God. Book of Exodus chapter 1, verse 11.
Bring it out.
Therefore, they did set over them taskmasters.
Right, just like in America. They set taskmasters over us, man. Go ahead.
To afflict them.
To do what?
To afflict them.
And they afflicted us, man. What a... Yeah. Right? You see this right here? What you think was going? What you think happened to him right there?
He got whipped.
Yep. By what?
A white man.
Right. You see what I'm saying? What about right here? What's going on? Right? What happened to his hand?
He got chopped off.
He got chopped off, right? What happened to your little sister's hand? He got chopped off, man. What's wrong? Why is he crying?
Chained up.
Huh?
He chained up.
Right, like a dog.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. What about this little man right here? What is he doing?
Picking cotton.
What? What is he doing? By how old is he?
At least his age, like 3.
3, right? And he 3 years old with a job.
Yeah.
And we had jobs at 3 years old, man. We was punching the clock at 3, man. What's going on right here?
They being judged by white people?
Uh-uh. What that say? Negroes for sale.
Oh,
this is an auction, bro. This is a sale.
Oh.
You ever been to a car auction?
Yeah.
they was doing that with us.
Oh, for like that.
Yeah.
The house.
Yeah. You see what I'm saying? So this is what that was going on in Egypt too.
Huh.
Go ahead.
Go back to this.
Nah.
Okay. Nah.
Therefore, they did set over them taskmasters to afflict them with their burdens.
Uh-huh.
And they built for Pharaoh treasure cities.
And then we built the White House. Did you know slaves built the White House?
Yeah.
Yeah, we built all these cities,
yeah,
man. And all this stuff was built by our forefathers, man. For free.
For free.
Go ahead.
Cities, Pithon and Ramses. But the more they afflicted them, the more they multiplied and grew.
Uh-huh.
And they were grieved because of the children of Israel.
Right.
And the Egyptians made the children of Israel to serve with rigor.
To what?
To serve with rigor.
Now we served in peace.
To serve with rigor.
And they made us serve with rigor. This was the life of your forefathers in ancient Egypt under Pharaoh and the Egyptians. Go ahead. You got some of our people call themselves Egyptians. When the Egyptians had us in slavery. That's why you notice there's no new thing under the sun. Our people call themselves American. They say, I'm American. Right, I see you got that red, white, and blue on right now, man. in that American spirit. Go ahead.
God. Verse 14. And they made their lives bitter.
And they did what?
And they made their lives bitter.
Hey, they made these men's lives was bitter. What type of life you think our foreparents had in America? Bad, right? Go ahead. And we hate them.
Con.
Right? You hate your foreparents? Huh? You don't know a lot about them. We telling you about them. Right? We telling you they suffer, man. Right? All right, this is you. This is you right here, bro.
Huh?
Hey, that's your son? That's your brother. Look, this is your brother. Like, this is him. Right? Go ahead.
God. Lives bitter with hard bondage.
With what?
With hard bondage.
With hard slavery. Read.
In mortar.
In what?
In mortar.
Go ahead.
And in brick. And in all manner of service in the field.
In the what?
In the field.
In the field. All manner of service in the field, man. Go ahead.
God. All their service wherein they made them serve was with rigor.
With rigor. Jump up to verse 10. Read verse 10. Why? Why did they do this to us?
God, verse 10. Come on, let us deal wisely with them, lest they multiply and it come to pass.
They say we can't let these niggas multiply.
Huh?
Right? That's why they kill you so much. Huh? It's too many of us, man. Go ahead.
When there falleth out any war, they join also unto our enemies,
right,
and fight against us, and so get them up out of the land.
Right. So, go back to Deuteronomy. Go back to Deuteronomy 28:68. So Egypt represents slavery, a bondage.
Huh.
So when the Lord said, "I'm going to bring you into Egypt again," He's not talking about ancient Egypt. He's talking about another slavery. Go ahead. You gotta get it. Go ahead.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68.
Bring it up.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt, slavery again with ships.
With what?
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
How do we come to America? With ships. Now, this didn't happen in the Bible, but God said it was going to happen. This is called a future prophecy. So Moses is prophesying, foretelling something that was going to happen in the future. This happened to our people in the 1600s. So who are you talking? This is talking about the white man. Can the damn Chinese man open the Bible and say, "Oh, that's my people"? Because what do we read earlier? These are the words which Moses spoke to all Israel. So he's talking to a nation of people. He's not talking to niggers. He's not talking to black people. Not talking to Africans. He's talking to the Israelites.
Fine.
Right? Go ahead.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again.
Hold on. Have we seen our homeland again, or are we still in America? We still in the same place we pick cotton at. Hey, you can get on, if you drive a certain place, you can still see the damn cotton fields.
Huh.
Right? Go ahead.
And there ye shall be sold.
Ye shall be what?
Ye shall be sold.
Hey, I just showed you our children being sold. Right? I want you to read an actual flyer. Come up here a little closer. Right, I want you to read this. This is a legit flyer. I want you to read that. It says, "Negroes for sale."
Yeah.
On the third day, Monday.
Oh, so far. I thought you meant to read that too.
No.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, this was a flyer. You know, brothers pass out flyers today, right? Yeah, so they made flyers, man. Hey, come to the Negro cell,
mm-hmm.
Right? So these are the things that happened to our forefathers. So when it says they were sold, who was sold? What's your last name? Where that come from? How you spell your last name?
M-C-C.
That sound like German, probably. Like Dutch. With cream.
M-C-C.
R-I.
M-O-N.
M-O-N.
M-O-N?
Yeah.
It sounds like Dutch.
Or Swedish.
Something like that.
Hey, I'm from Texas, man. Huntsville, Texas. Where your people from?
I got people all over.
Madison, Alabama.
Damn.
So you should kind of get into this. All right, this is a whole, this all the people. At one time, there was white men that had your name. And that's how, when we got off the slave ships, if you was Jackson, a white man named Jackson branded the name of the slave.
Right. Yep.
And all your children on that plantation had to have the name of the slave master, right? So you was on the McCrimmon slave plantation. And you can look these things up today. And they had in Huntsville, Madison County, Alabama, and they had some bread. They had many plantations all throughout the South.
You want it?
Yeah. Assembly as early as 1832, patrols were reaffirmed. Each patrol leader was required to make a true return on oath, a judge, the clerk of his town. So they had them slave patrols out there, man, on the plantation, right? They had slave catchers. That's what police come from.
Huh.
The police department that you got today, they used to be slave patrols. So when the slaves would escape, they would send them, they had to go catch the slave.
Slave catchers.
Right? And your name goes back.
My name comes from the white man.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just mine too.
Mine.
All of our people.
All of us.
Right?
That curse.
Give me Deuteronomy 28 and 49. Because we didn't get off the slave ship speaking English. We're not Englishmen. So how do we have the same names as white people? Yeah. You got DeMar Jackson. Right? You got Michael Jackson. Right? And you got Andrew Jackson, an old slave master on the damn, what dollar he on?
20.
On the $20 bill.
Yeah.
On the what?
The 20.
The 20?
The Andrew Jackson?
Yeah.
20.
See that? Wow. On the $20 bill. Say we you know what I'm saying? We ain't bought that money no more.
No.
All right. Go ahead.
Verse 49.
Bring it out.
It said, "The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far, from the ends of the earth,
right,
as swift as the eagle flyeth."
Whose symbol is the eagle?
Is it white man's symbol?
Yeah, America.
America.
Right?
All of them.
Yeah. Yeah, see? All these Edomite, all these white man kingdoms, America, Russia, Germany, Rome, the Vatican, Edom, they all got the eagle. Right?
Yeah.
Even in Egypt, we was in slavery under Egypt. They had the eagle. Right? And look at America. The same damn symbol.
Yeah.
Right? So the Bible uses similitudes. The Lord is identifying who your enemy is through code, right? Through the scriptures. Right? That's why you can't learn this in the church. But they're not reading this and breaking it down like this, right? Go ahead.
A nation whose tongue.
Whose what?
A nation whose tongue.
Whose language, whose tongue, read.
Thou shalt not understand.
We can understand English, but now we all speak English. We got the, hey, they would kill us for reading.
Come.
We couldn't read or write.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah. Right, and they used to taunt us for that, man. But they messed up now. Right, they should have never let us learn how to read.
Right.
You see that? Now we can read, brother. You see what I'm saying? Now go back to 68 one more time.
Come on. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. But the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
What people are we sold to?
Right.
And what does God call them? Read it again.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
Yeah. So we sold unto our enemies, right? Like, look over here. All right here.
All right here.
Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. What's going on right here?
That's a kid.
Oh,
that's a kid?
Yeah.
It's a kid.
It's a man.
That's
a kid.
Yeah. Why are they doing this to him? Are they sad?
Oh, yeah,
are they taking pictures?
They taking selfies.
Yeah, they taking a selfie with their whole family. Yeah. Right? Look at this brother. Look at this brother. Yeah. Look at this brother.
right? Who is that?
You know who that is? That's Emmett Till. You ever heard about Emmett Till?
All right, he was a 13-year-old kid.
That's a kid?
Yeah, a white woman lied on him, right? And that's what they did to him. And she just admitted that she did it, right? And what you think happened to her?
Nothing.
Right? They said it was a long time ago, right? What happened to Bill Cosby when all them white women came and said he did something from a long time ago?
He got
his ass locked up, didn't he?
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
He's old, too.
Yeah, and he old, too. They say she too old. It happened a long time ago. Leave her alone. Right? But yeah, who cares about these people? Who cares about these people? Do we care about these people? No. We don't even mention this no more.
Huh?
Like, we just want to be cool and have a good time in America. Right? And chase a bag. Right?
At least some people starting to like still make moves about like that. That's like this.
They're them white people. They making money off of what happened to us.
Oh, yeah, right.
They make billions of dollars of what happened. And they showing you. But we reading it. Where are we reading this at? What are we reading about this in the Bible, right? Right? So now read that last part one more time and finish it up.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bondmen and bondwomen, and no man shall buy you.
And nobody's gonna save us out of this situation. That's why in 2022, we still at the bottom. We still more. Just George Floyd, that just happened so, not too long ago. Everybody rising up. I thought Martin Luther King ended that.
Right.
They got a damn Martin Luther King Day, right? They got an MLK Street in every city.
Every hood.
Right?
Yeah.
And what happened to him? Martin Luther King.
He got killed by white
men. Yep.
Even the nigga that's begging to be peaceful with you, yeah. Right? Because the Lord said nobody can save us out of here. Who's gonna save us out of here?
Only the Lord.
That's right, brother. That's right, brother. So, who did this happen to? Did this happen to, because the so-called white man said this happened to him. I mean, you got white people in the land, they say they Jewish. Is this Jesus? Yeah, right? That's Jesus, right? All right, so now look. Give me the book of Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14.
I saw Jesus in my dream.
You saw him in your dream? Did he look like this?
Yeah.
He looked like this? All right, let's see if you saw Jesus.
The book of Revelations, chapter 1.
You had a nightmare.
Come.
If you had a dream and you saw this man as Jesus, that was a damn nightmare.
Come.
All right, this is the slave master.
Right.
All right? So let's read about it. Give me Revelation 1 and 1.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 1.
Bring it out.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
What's the root word of revelation? What's the root word? Huh?
Reveal.
Reveal. So this is the revealing of the Messiah. All right, who you said you saw in your dream. Go ahead.
Come.
Give me the book of Sirach, chapter 34 from the top. Go ahead.
Verse 13, in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man.
Right?
Clothed.
Now look. Now this is the image that the world thinks of Jesus, right? Now, what we're reading to you is the revealing of the Lord. I want you to start at verse 10.
Verse 10.
Right.
I was in the spirit on the Lord's day.
So this is John the Revelator, all right, on the island of Patmos around 90, some from between 90 and 96 AD. Right? He said he was in the spirit. And what's the Lord's day? The Sabbath day. Today. Yeah. Saturday. Not Sunday, right? We'll show you that too. Go ahead.
And heard behind me a great voice.
If you hear a great voice behind you, what's the first thing you're going
to
do?
Listen to it.
Right now, if you hear something behind you, what's the first thing you're gonna do?
Turn around.
You're gonna turn around, right? So John the Revelator saw a great voice behind him. Read.
As of a trumpet, saying, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last. And
whatever you see when you turn around, read.
Write in a book.
Do what?
Write in a book.
And we read in the book. He wrote it down. And we're gonna read what he wrote down.
Right.
And we're gonna see if he looked like this guy that was in your dream.
Right.
All right. Now,
verse 12.
Jump down to 12.
Verse 12. And I turned to see the voice that spake to me.
So he turned and see what the hell this voice was. Go ahead.
And begin to turn, I saw seven golden candlesticks.
He saw what?
Seven golden candlesticks.
And do you ever see seven golden candlesticks behind this guy? Right? But you have seven golden candlesticks right here, right? Go ahead. Which is the menorah. Go ahead.
And in the midst of the seven candlesticks.
And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, read.
One like unto the Son of Man.
So he saw the Jesus. He saw the Messiah. Go ahead.
Clothed with a garment down to the foot.
And he had a garment on down to the foot, read.
And girt about the paps with a golden girdle.
And he had on a golden girdle. Now just stop right there. If we didn't have nothing else written, and that's all we had to go on, who would you say it was that had a garment on to the foot with a gold girdle on? Is that a white man? With a gold girdle on?
Who liked the stunt?
Read.
His head and his hair.
Now it's gonna give you the hair on his head and the hair on his beard. All right, read.
Were white like wool.
Well, what?
Were white like wool.
Is this white and woolly? Cause now John saw the Lord. This is not white and woolly. No, John is who's in the Bible. Yeah. Read.
That's all I got you.
Read.
Were white like wool.
Right.
As white as snow.
Right.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Now they gave you the color of his hair and the texture. Yeah. Like your hair. Right? Yeah. It's white and woolly hair. Like the elder right there. See the elder? See, got the white woolly beard.
Alright.
Go ahead.
Con. And his feet.
And his feet. If you take your socks off and take, I don't know what. I don't know what's going on, but if you take them off, is your color on your feet the same as the rest of your body?
No.
It's not?
It's the top of your foot?
What the hell wrong with you?
Like,
your feet different color in your body?
It's the same color, but
just light up your tan.
I'm confounded. Go ahead.
The sock, your feet don't see that much sun.
Nah, your feet the same color as the rest of
your feet is the same color.
You don't have damn different color. Go ahead.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
What color is brass?
Brass is like a golden brown type.
Yeah, brass is a derivative of brown. Right, go ahead. It's gonna get deeper though. Go ahead.
As if they burn in a furnace.
You burn anything in the oven, what color is it?
Red.
Wait.
I mean red. You mean when you burn it?
As if they burned in a furnace.
All right, let's say he was white.
Yeah.
What happens when you burn white rice?
It turned black.
It turned what?
Black.
It turned black, right?
Yeah.
So what color is Jesus?
Black.
Right, so why you don't ever see this image?
I don't know.
So you had a dream that you saw this guy.
Yeah.
That's why I said it was a nightmare. Come. Read this.
Book of Sirach, chapter 34 from the top.
Bring it out.
The hope of a man void of understanding.
Because you were void of understanding. You didn't know the truth. So when you had your dream, you probably told grandma and them and everybody, I seen Jesus. Grandma, I seen Jesus in my dream last night. Yeah, she probably said, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Yeah, the Holy Spirit came upon you. Yeah, go ahead.
The hopes of a man void of understanding are vain and false.
Are what?
Are vain and false.
Are vain and they are false, read.
And dreams.
And what?
And dreams.
And what?
And dreams.
And dreams, read.
Lift up fools.
Do what?
Lift up fools.
And dreams lift up fools. You see what I'm saying? So no, that dream was false. Right, keep going.
God, verse 2. Whoso regardeth dreams.
Whoso regarded a dream. You regarded that dream as I had a dream. And you probably tell everybody that. I saw Jesus. Yeah. All right, read.
God. Whoso regardeth dreams is like him that catcheth at a shadow.
That what?
That catcheth at a shadow.
So if you taking that dream as this is Jesus, you'll be like you trying to chase your down, catch your shadow. And so you just. It's impossible. Go ahead.
And followeth after the wind.
And that's like you trying to chase the wind, trying to race the wind. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
The vision of dreams is the resemblance of one thing to another, even as the likeness of a face to a face.
That's it on that. All right, brother. So that's not Jesus. All right. Jesus looked like you.
All right.
And Jesus went through the same thing that we go through, right?
Uh-huh.
All right? What happened to Jesus?
He was killed.
Right. Give me Acts chapter 5 and 29. Uh-huh. How was he killed?
Hung on a cross with his nails.
That's right. right? Kind of like these guys, right? Kind of like these guys, man. So read that.
The book of Acts, chapter 5 and verse 29.
Bring it out.
Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than men.
Right.
The God of our fathers raised up Jesus, whom you slew and hanged on a tree.
Which one of these is Jesus? Oh yeah, which one is Jesus? It's Jesus. Now we're not saying that this is him, but we're saying based on what we read, this is a depiction.
It describes.
Right, it describes, it tell you what he looked like. Uh-huh. So we're not saying this is what he looked like. All right, so don't go looking for this guy. All right? We're saying this is not him. Yeah. That's what we're saying. All right, go ahead. So it's talking about the Messiah, the black Messiah. Go ahead.
Him hath God raised up, it's like it. Him hath God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior.
He's a prince, and you said he coming to save us, right?
Yeah.
Ain't no white man coming to save no black people.
Nah.
Right? If he's coming back, we going back into slavery.
Nah.
Right.
All right, you want to go in slavery? All right, go ahead.
For to give repentance to Israel.
To who?
To Israel.
Read.
And forgiveness of sins.
And forgiveness of sins, man. All right, so who did Christ come for? What people?
If it's the white people.
Jesus came.
He came, but he for us, but again, it's right. Like you said, we're going back to the sin.
Yeah, but we just read who this is talking about. This is a black man.
Yeah.
He got it.
So who is Jesus coming for?
Us.
Right. Right, so he's coming for us.
Huh.
All right, who is us? Who are we?
Black people.
Brother, black people. This is black.
Well, African American.
You're not African, brother. Look on the side. Right? Who we just read about? Go back to Deuteronomy again.
Deuteronomy.
Give me Exodus 3 and 10.
Oh, Israel.
Get Exodus 3 and 10.
Huh. The book of Exodus chapter 3.
Who is God's chosen people? Read that.
The book of Exodus chapter 3 and verse 10.
Bring it out.
Come now, therefore, and I will send thee unto Pharaoh, that thou mayest bring forth my people, the children of Israel.
The who?
The children of Israel.
The children of Israel. All right, so who are you, brother?
A child of Israel.
That's right. Right. And who is Israel? Who is Israel? That's us, right? Give me that. Israel is our forefather. Jacob. Right? Nobody, you ever heard of Jacob? All right, so Jacob is our forefather. All right, we're going to read about your forefather real quick. All right, read that.
Book of Genesis, chapter 32, verse 28.
Bring it up.
And he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel.
So Jacob's name was changed by the Most High to Israel.
None.
All right, go ahead.
For as a prince hast thou.
As a what?
For as a prince.
A nigga.
As a prince.
A coon.
As a prince.
A black man.
As a prince.
A thug.
As a prince.
A gangster.
For as a prince.
A basketball player.
For as a prince.
An R&B singer.
For as a prince.
The Lord said you a prince. That's what your name means. Israel in the Hebrew is Yasher Allah. Means he prince power. Because we have power with the Most High God. Because God just destroyed the Egyptians for us. Right? And the Lord is going to do the same thing and deliver us out of America. So your name means a prince that has power with God. That's what your name means. That's why, you know, calling yourself a color in a crayon box, that's why it's so, you know, foolish.
Yeah.
All right? And it's important to come back to who you are. You're an Israelite from the tribe of Judah.
Right.
All right? That's the same tribe Jesus came from. Did you know that? Give me Hebrews 7, 14. Give me Jeremiah 14, 2.
In the book of Hebrews, chapter 7 and verse 14. For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah.
That what?
That our Lord sprang out of Judah.
You from the same tribe as Christ.
Huh?
You got the same blood running through your body as Christ.
That's right.
If Christ was in the earth right now, they call him a nigga. Did you know they call this nigga in the Bible? You didn't know that? Read this first. Get that Acts 13. Yeah.
Book of Job, chapter 30, verse 30.
Bring it up.
My skin is black upon me.
My what?
My skin is black upon me.
So you got so-called black people in the Bible. And it's not white people. All right? Give me Jeremiah 14 and 2. Let's read about the real Jews.
Book of Jeremiah, chapter 14, verse 2.
Bring it up.
Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof languish. They are black.
They are what?
They are black.
No, they white.
They are black.
What color are the Jews? They black. So why the Jewish people are white today? They stole your identity. They said, they told you African American, they said, we're gonna be them. That's identity theft.
DJ, wake him up.
Cause they don't want you to know that you the true prince of the art. All right, bring this up.
Book of Acts chapter 13 and 1. Now there were in the church that was at Antioch certain prophets and teachers, as Barnabas and Simeon, that were called nigger.
What was they called?
That were called nigger.
What?
That were called nigger.
What they call us?
Man.
Wake them up,
Right. Is these, do white people get called nigger? Who get called nigger? So what color are these people?
Niggers.
Right. So what color are they?
Nigger. Oh, black.
Right. So who's the people of the book? Is it a white man or is it us?
Right.
It's us. We the people of the book, brother.
Right.
That's right.
I'm gonna get one more. Bring this up.
The Song of Solomon, chapter 1, verse 5.
Yo,
I am black, but comely.
But comely. He said, I am black, but beautiful, but handsome. That's what comely means, right? So he was showing you in the Bible that the images and the pictures that they put before us, right, it's not the truth, right? Because this is how the images used to look before they whitewashed them. Here it is. You got the damn Pope bowing down to the black image. Yeah, because they do this in secret, right? Because they know this. You see that? So we're showing you that our people are greater than they know. Give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Is everybody equal? Huh? Why not?
Because of the white people.
I'm saying though, are we equal to them? Are we the same?
We bleed the same blood, but they don't feel like we're the same.
But what do you think? You think we equal? Think we should be equal? Should we be equal?
I feel like we should.
All right, let's see what God says.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7 and verse 6.
Read out.
For thou art an holy people.
Who is the Lord talking to? The Israelites.
Right.
Read.
Unto the Lord thy God.
So God said we are holy people. We separate. Read.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
Hey, oh, you think we special? Is something different about us?
Right.
We got that swag.
Right.
All right. Don't we do everything better?
Jump off the roof.
We add more flavor to everything. Yeah. Go ahead.
Above all people.
What?
Above all people.
Now we equal.
Above all people.
What the Lord say?
Above all people.
God say we above all people. Read.
That are upon the face of the earth.
So the Lord said out of everybody he made, we better than everybody. That's why they hate you. Because they know we better. That's why they work so hard to destroy us. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All right, bring this up.
Book of Matthew chapter 5, verse 13.
Read
it up. Ye are the salt of the earth.
What the Lord say?
Ye are the salt of the earth.
Right, that's why they put big ass picture of LeBron James outside to sell the tickets, right? Yeah. All right, are they gonna put Steve Kerr on the damn building to sell tickets? Right? And they're gonna get down Mike Miller, right?
No,
nobody want to see that, right? You got 10 players on the court. You got 5 people on and 5 on this team, all right? You got 5 Luka Doncics against 5 Luka Doncics. You gonna sit and watch that all day? Yeah. Nobody want to see that, bro.
Yeah.
Right? You want to see Steph? You want to see LeBron?
Right.
Right? You want to see our people,
wow,
man? Cause we the salt of the earth, bro.
All
right? That's why they hate us, but they don't want to let us go.
Huh?
Cause they need niggas, man. All right? They need damn R. Kelly. Damn, who else? Usher, right?
Yeah.
You need them, man. You can't sit there and have that, listen to goddamn, what's his name? Yeah, all day on the radio. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They gonna go to sleep.
Right.
Yeah.
Right, go ahead, read it again.
God, ye are the salt of the earth, but if the salt has lost its savor.
But we the salt of the earth. Like, trying to cook some food with no season. You can't do that. Like, we are the season in the earth. But if the salt lost its flavor, go ahead.
Wherewith shall it be salted?
See that, man? We lost it, though.
It is therefore good for nothing.
It is what?
It is therefore good for nothing.
What good is for you to be the salt of the earth if you're going to be a nigga in America? Right? If you're going to kill each other. Right? If you're going to continue in sin. If you refuse to stand up and be the people that God called you to be. What's the point? It's good for nothing, brother. Right?
So give me the book of Deuteronomy 10 and 12. Now what? Now you know you're an Israelite. What do we got to do now? What should you think? What do you think you should be doing now? Do you remember why God put us in this position? Why he punished us? What do we do? You forgot? Go to Deuteronomy 28 and 15 again.
Book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee.
You're reading it too fast.
Come. But it shall come to pass.
God said it shall come to pass, meaning it will happen in the future. Read.
If thou wilt not hearken.
If y'all don't listen. Hearken means to listen. Read.
Unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So what did we do for all these curses to come on us? We didn't listen, right? We broke the commandments. So what do you think we should be doing? Give me Daniel, huh?
We should be listening.
Yeah, we should be listening to what?
The Lord.
And where is the voice of the Lord at?
Behind
you. It's not behind you. I'm looking behind you. Where's the word of God?
In the Bible.
In the Bible. Right? Because how are we reading? How do we know who we are? We just read it. Because the Lord had these things recorded in a book. Give me 2 Edges 15 and 1. 9 and 11. Give me 2 Edges 15 and 1. Hold that.
The book of 2 Esdras, chapter 15. And verse 1, behold, speak thou in the ears, it's like you speak thou into the ears of my people.
Who's God's people? The Israelites. That's why we out here talking to you now. Speak thou in the ears of my people, read.
The words of prophecy.
And we just were at prophecy. Prophecy allows us to identify who we are, read.
Which I will put in thy mouth.
So the Lord put the words in a prophet's mouth. And what did they do? Read.
Said the Lord, and caused them to be written in paper.
And do what?
And caused them to be written in paper.
That's why he's reading the words on the paper. He caused them to be written in paper. Go ahead.
For they are faithful and true.
Because they are faithful and they are true. How do we know that? Everything God said will happen to us, it happened.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So guess what? Everything that he said he's about to do is going to happen. Right. So now, read this real quick.
Book of Daniel, chapter 9, verse 11. Yea, all Israel hath transgressed.
All who?
All Israel hath transgressed.
All of us. We all transgressed. Read.
Yea, all Israel hath transgressed thy law.
Thy what?
Thy law.
The law. This is all about the law that God gave us we broke. If you break the so-called white man law, what are you going to do? He's going to lock you up. Yeah, you're right. He might kill you.
Right?
He might take you in a damn alley somewhere. Right? And drop you off and act like another brother did it. Tell me, we got him. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Go ahead.
Even by departing.
Read.
That they might not obey thy voice. Therefore, the curse is poured upon us.
Therefore what?
The curse is poured upon us.
The curse is poured upon one people. Everybody's not under the curses. We are. Right? The Chinaman, there's no Chinese hoods and ghettos. You can't go to the damn east side of Orlando and see the Chinese down. And the there's no Chinese projects. Go ahead.
And the oath that is written in the law of Moses.
In the what?
In the law of Moses.
That's why we have to go back to the law of Moses. Give me John 5 and 45. Go ahead.
The servant of God, because we have sinned against him.
Because we sinned against God. You know what sin is? What do you think sin is?
Doing bad stuff?
Well, I mean, something bad I may do to you. Is that a sin? Because I do something that's bad to you? How do you determine what's good and what's bad? Get 1 John 3 and 4. Bring it
Book
up.
Of 1 John chapter 3 and verse 4.
Bring it up.
Whosoever committed sin.
Whoever committed sin, brother, read.
Transgresses also the law.
Everything is going back to the law. That means you broke the law. And that's what we did. That's why we're here, right? Go ahead.
For sin is the transgression of the law.
Because sin is the transgression of the law, right? So it's not you just doing something bad, it's when you broke the law. Because if I do something, but the Lord never wrote it in the law not to do it, that's not a sin. You just don't like it. You see what I'm saying? So sin is when you break the laws of God. So how do you return and start keeping the laws of God?
I start to listen.
by start listening. Meaning you have to go learn what the Lord what requires of us. All right, so give me Deuteronomy 10 and 12.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 12. And now Israel.
Now who?
And now Israel.
Who are you talking to? So is he talking to you? Right, so now the Bible is personal now.
God.
All right, go ahead.
What doeth the Lord thy God require of thee?
What does God require of us, brother? What should we be doing? That's right, read.
But to fear the Lord thy God.
But to fear God, read.
To walk in all his ways.
To walk in all his ways, not the ways of America.
God.
Because the ways of America are going to get us killed in these last days.
God.
Go ahead.
And to love him.
And to what?
And to love him.
And to love God, read.
And to serve him, so like, and to serve the Lord thy God.
Right.
With all thy heart. And with all thy soul.
Uh-huh.
To keep the commandments of the Lord.
To do what?
To keep the commandments of the Lord.
What do we got to do?
To keep the commandments of the Lord.
What does his brother got to do?
To keep the commandments of the Lord.
What little brother got to do?
To keep the commandments of the Lord.
We got to keep the commandments of the Most High, man.
Come.
All right? Do our people keep the commandments of God? Hell no. Hell no. Right? Give me the book of Leviticus chapter 11 and verse 7. Come. You eat pork?
I got it.
Come. You bacon? You like bacon? Yesterday you got extra bacon? How many strips you get? Three strips?
Yeah,
extra bacon. See that, man? See, two strips.
Bro, yeah, right? Yeah, regular. Yeah, three extra bacon. Yeah.
You got extra bacon? You got extra bacon, man. All right, so now, let's read a commandment from God, all right? All right, so bring it up.
Book of Exodus chapter 11, verse 7.
Bring it out.
And the swine.
And the what?
And the swine.
What's the swine, brother? It's a pig, all right? Swine, pork, bacon. Mm-hmm. Right? Go ahead.
Though he divide the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he cheweth not the cud.
Right?
He is unclean to you.
He is what?
He is unclean to you.
No, he clean.
He is unclean to you.
It's good.
He is unclean to you.
It tastes good.
He is unclean to you.
It smell good.
He is unclean to you.
God said it's unclean unto who? Us. Meaning what? The so-called, it's not unclean to the white man. He can eat all the bacon he want. We can't eat it. Remember, we was the ones on the bottom of the slave ship. God didn't punish them for breaking no commandment. We got punished for it. Go ahead.
Of their flesh shall ye not eat.
No, we can eat it.
Of their flesh shall ye not eat.
Of their flesh shall you not eat. What does that mean? You can't eat pork.
Right.
Right? Yeah. It's just that simple. But what do our people do? We eat that big nasty ham. Mm-hmm. We put that butter on it and that honey. And that pineapple's on it, right? Are you gonna eat that? When grandmama make that big ham, you gonna eat it?
Yeah.
I mean, give me Isaiah 66. Give me Isaiah 66 and 15. So look, so listen, if you don't stop eating pork, when the Lord come back, instead of saving you, this is what he gonna do. Read that.
Come. The book of Isaiah, chapter 66 and verse 15.
Yeah.
For behold, the Lord will come with fire.
How's the Lord coming back? Read again.
Behold, the Lord will come with fire.
With hugs.
With fire.
With kisses.
With fire.
The Lord, is he coming with to give you a hug? What are he coming with? To what?
He coming with fire.
You already in hell. You already in hell. What is he coming with?
Fire.
Fire. Right? Go ahead.
And with his chariots like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury.
His what?
To render his anger with fury.
Is the Lord, when he come back, is he going to be happy? Is he going to be excited? Or is he going to be angry? Angry with fury. Read.
And his rebuke with flames of fire.
And he's going to rebuke this earth with flames of fire. Read.
For by fire and by his sword.
By what?
But by fire and by his sword.
So the Lord coming with fire and a sword. So with that same fire and with the sword, read.
Will the Lord plead with all flesh?
Read.
And the slain of the Lord shall be many.
So the Lord is coming back as a serial arsonist.
Come.
He's going to be a serial killer.
Come.
The slain of the Lord is going to be many. A lot of people he's coming back to kill. All right? The Lord is coming back to save and to destroy.
Come.
It's up to us. It's up to you whether you get saved or whether you get destroyed. If you like that bacon that damn much, all right? If it's that good, brother, hey, go ahead, have at it.
I'll eat it once in a while.
Go ahead.
They that sanctify themselves.
Like you sanctify yourself, read.
And purify themselves in the garden.
Uh-huh, in grandma's house. The garden is grandma's house.
Con.
Right? Grandma's house is in back of, I mean, the garden is in the back of the church.
Con.
Right? Go ahead, we're passed with Acts 10 on the wall.
Con.
You got Acts 10 on the damn chalkboard. Right? With the all the unclean beasts and four feet. Go ahead.
Behind one's tree.
Uh-huh.
In the midst. Eating swine's flesh.
Doing what?
Eating swine's flesh.
Eating swine flesh that the Lord said we shall not eat. Uh-huh. Read.
And the abomination. And the mouse shall be consumed together.
Shall be what?
Shall be consumed together.
What's that going to happen in that fire?
Shall be consumed together.
So what is God going to do to those people that's eating pork when he come back?
Destroy them all.
He's going to destroy them.
Right.
Right? So I'm going to ask you again. Are you going to repent and stop eating pork? Or are you going to continue to eat it every now and then?
I know that, yeah.
Now that you know, you going to stop?
Yeah.
All praise
God.
All praise God. Hey, that's all the Lord asking of us.
That's it.
Time.
Right? Give me Acts 3 and 19. Give me Acts 3 and 19. Hey, ain't that so simple?
Yeah.
All right? You was doing something you didn't know. Hey, the Lord could have been killed us.
Time.
But he showed us what? Mercy and grace.
Yep.
He allowed you to come before the servants of the Lord today and learn these things that you didn't know.
Time.
All right, that's what's happening in the last days. A lot of people rejecting it and a lot of people coming up and receiving it.
Time.
All right, read that.
Look at Acts chapter 3, verse 19.
No.
Repent ye therefore and be converted.
Do what?
Repent ye therefore and be converted.
What does it mean to convert? It means to change. Convert, that word means to change. So how do you repent? By making the change, right? And what changes you? Yeah, when the Lord said repent and be converted, how do you do that?
By not doing what you were doing before.
Right, but how?
You gotta
get Psalms 19:7. So let's see.
The book of Psalms chapter 19 and verse 7. The law of the Lord is perfect.
No, something wrong with it.
The law of the Lord is perfect.
No, it's wrong.
The law of the Lord is perfect.
It's evil.
The law of the Lord is perfect.
The law, statutes, and commandments that we broke of God is what?
Perfect.
It's perfect, right? Read.
Converting the soul.
Doing what?
Converting the soul.
What converts you? Read it again. For the
law of the Lord is perfect.
The law of the Lord is what? It's perfect doing what?
Converting the soul.
Doing what?
Converting the soul.
The law of the Lord is perfect doing what?
Converting the soul.
Go back to Acts 3 and 19.
Look at Acts chapter 3 verse 19. Repent ye therefore and be converted.
Do what?
Repent ye therefore and be converted.
What converts you?
Change.
And how do you do that?
By repenting.
And how do you do that?
By listening to the Bible and the Lord.
And what? And what did he give us to do?
He gave us rules.
Right.
The law of the Lord is
give me Psalm 19:7.
The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul.
What is perfect at converting your soul?
The law of the Lord.
The law of the Lord. Give me Acts 3 and 19.
Look at Acts 3 verse 19. Repent ye therefore and be converted.
Repent and be converted. What converts you?
The law of the Lord.
The law of the Lord, man. Right? Let's read the law of the Lord. Give me Leviticus 11:7.
John, book of Leviticus. Oh. Lock you. Book of Leviticus chapter 11 verse 7.
Bring it out.
And the swine, though he divide the hoof and be cloven-footed, yet he cheweth not the cud.
So the pork cheweth not the cud, read.
He is unclean to you.
It's unclean to us, read.
Of their flesh shall ye not eat.
Of their flesh shall you not eat, right? So you didn't know this before. You was in sin, right? Because sin is what? Transgression of the law. We just read a law that we're not supposed to do. Give me Acts 17 and 30.
Look at Acts chapter 17. Verse 30.
Yo.
At the times of this ignorance, God winked at it.
In your ignorance, God winked at it. When you didn't know these things and you was eating that bacon, licking your damn fingers, man. All right? Somebody let me get one more strip. Go ahead.
God winked at
it. God winked at it. Meaning what? He didn't kill you. All right? He allowed you to live, to come and hear the truth and give you an opportunity to change and not do it again. Read.
But now.
But what?
But now.
But what?
But now.
But when?
But now.
Tomorrow.
But now.
Next week.
But now.
But now, brother. Today, read.
Commandeth all men everywhere to repent.
To what?
To repent.
And repentance meaning what? Repent literally means to return.
Yeah.
Right. We got to return to what? The law, statutes, and commandments. Right? So now, give me the book Give me the book of Exodus 28.
Book of Exodus chapter 20, verse 8.
Straight up.
Remember the Sabbath. Book of Exodus chapter 20, verse 8. Straight remember up. The Sabbath day.
What the Lord say?
Remember the Sabbath day.
So we got to remember the Shabbat. When is the Sabbath day? Is it Sunday morning?
Saturday.
Right. Saturday, read.
To keep it holy.
To do what?
To keep it holy.
To keep it holy. Holy means separate. Meaning on the Sabbath day, it's different than the other days. Yeah. All right, go ahead.
6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work.
The Lord says 6 days, we got 6 days to labor and do all our work. Read.
But the seventh day.
But the what day?
But the seventh day.
But the seventh day, read.
Is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God.
It's the Sabbath of the Most High God. All right, it's a holy day. Like today. Brother's not working today. Hey, brother's coming out here to congregate together, man. All right, go ahead.
In it thou shalt not do any work.
You're not supposed to work on the Sabbath day. It's a day of rest. All right, but what do our people do? They working, they going to the club on Saturday. All manner of wickedness, the most wickedness happened on Saturday. Profaning the Lord's Sabbath day. So now you have to start to learn and keep the Sabbath day holy. Right, you should be reading. Hey, you can come out here with us on the Saturday, man. Hey, we out here every week.
Right.
Go ahead.
For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea and all that in them is, and rested.
And what?
And rested.
And worked.
And rested.
And rested, read.
The seventh day.
The seventh day. Hey, the Lord gave us a day off. Right? Hey, the Lord gave us a day off to rest, and niggas won't take it. Right? A lot of niggas die. A lot of niggas kill. Right? A lot of niggas sell a lot of drugs on Saturdays. Right? Instead of resting, man. You know? Go ahead.
Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day.
He blessed today, read.
And hallowed it.
And hallowed it. He separated it from the other days. All right. So give me the book of Nehemiah 10 and 31.
The book of Nehemiah chapter 10 and verse 31. If the people of the land bring ware or individuals on the Sabbath day to sell, that we would not buy it of them on the Sabbath day or on the holy day.
Like, so the Lord said, when you go to captivity and the world don't want you to know who you are, and they tell you the Sabbath day is Sunday morning, right? So you can go into the nasty churches and eat all that nasty pork in there, right? Mm-hmm. Hey, the Lord said, look, and they open up their stores on the Sabbath day, hey, we're not buying it. We're not shopping on the Sabbath day. All right, we're gonna buy everything we gotta get Friday, all right? Or we're gonna wait till after the sun goes down on Saturday, and then we're gonna go by. Right. So we're gonna prepare and make sure we got everything we need on the Sabbath day. Why? Because we fear the Lord. And we wanna get salvation. And we know what the Lord did to us, right? So these are the things that you have to start doing. So it's no buying, no selling on the Sabbath day. What else can we do on the Sabbath day?
Book of Exodus chapter 35, verse 2.
Right.
6 days shall work be done, but on the seventh day there shall be to you a holy day. A Sabbath of rest to the Lord.
A what?
A Sabbath of rest to the Lord.
Read.
Whosoever doeth work therein shall be put to death.
Shall what?
Shall be put to death.
Hey, don't get put to death out here. You trying to figure out why brother's dropping dead every day? He kind of got in a car accident, right? And the Lord is bringing judgment, man. Because our people don't what? Keep the commandments. Go ahead.
Ye shall kindle no fire.
You shall what?
Ye shall kindle no fire.
Don't be out there on the damn grill on Saturday, right? Tell Uncle Junebug I'm not going to the damn barbecue on Saturday. It's the Sabbath day.
Right.
Go ahead.
Ye shall kindle no fire throughout your habitation upon the Sabbath day.
All right, so there's no kindling of fire on the Sabbath day. All right, brother. What about seafood? What kind of seafood you like? You like jumbo shrimp, crab, lobster? You like the lobster? You get the big ones?
Oh, yeah.
The butt on there with the, yeah. All right. So let's see what the Lord said about seafood, right?
God, book of Leviticus.
Because who created the shrimps and the crabs and the lobster? Who created it? Yeah, God created it. God created the swine and he told you it's nasty. Don't eat it. Right? Because why? Why did the Lord telling us not to eat stuff, but he not telling nobody else?
I'm trying to say this.
Because you special. Uh-huh. And you're above everybody else. You're a prince. Can't put anything in your body. Right? You got to put the things that he made for you to eat, not the things that he made that's going to destroy your body and destroy your mind. Go ahead.
Book of Leviticus chapter 11, verse 9.
No.
These shall ye eat of all that are in the water.
The Lord has made it simple. The Lord said, look, I made the water and I made everything in the water. There's some things in the water you can eat. There's some things in the water you might not want to eat. Yeah. I think I'm going to listen to the man that made it and gave it a purpose, right? Right. So he's going to tell you. Go ahead.
God. Whatsoever hath fins and scales.
He said, whatever got fins and scales. Fins and scales. Fins and scales, right? Read.
God. Fins and scales in the waters, in the seas, and in the rivers, them shall ye eat.
So you can eat anything that has what?
Fins and scales.
You can eat that, right? Go ahead.
And all that have no fins and scales in the seas.
What do you think? What do you think about the things that don't have fins and scales out of the water? What do you think God about to say? What? Don't eat it, right? Let's see. Let's see if you're right.
And all that have not fins and scales in the seas and in the rivers, of all that move in the waters, and of any living thing which is in the waters, they shall be an abomination unto you.
They shall be what?
They shall be an abomination unto you.
Give me that, the Lord hated abomination. Bring it out. Keep going.
Oh, God. They shall be even an abomination unto you. Ye shall not eat of their flesh.
Ye shall what?
Ye shall not eat of their flesh.
So now, does the jumbo shrimp that the white man throw on the plate and make a delicacy, does that have fins and scales? No. It has leg, little them little legs like a roach. Uh-huh. And a little, yeah, it's a roach, right?
Huh.
Yeah. The Lord said you can't eat shrimp no more. Right? Because what does a shrimp do in the water? Why did the Lord create the shrimp to do? It's the water's filtration system. So when the other animals take a shit, the Lord created animals to go clean it up and eat it.
Nah.
Yeah. That's why when you crack it open, you think that's the good stuff. Yeah, that's that. Yeah.
That's doo-doo.
Yeah. That's doo-doo.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So the Lord don't want us eating that because we're his chosen people and he loves us.
Nah.
And he say, look, don't eat that. Same thing with the lobster. So if it don't have fins and scale, it wasn't made to eat. Yeah. So only thing you can eat salmon, right? Fish, yeah. Uh-huh. All right?
Not all fish
have fins and what?
Scales.
And scales. All right, uh-huh. See what I'm saying? So that's easy to understand. Is that hard? Tell you gotta, you go to church on Sunday?
Sometime.
Go tell your
pastor. I was going.
You going tomorrow?
Yeah, I was.
You
was?
Yeah,
kind.
That was. And you might not want to go in there. If you do go, you should have questions.
Right.
You should go ask him. Say, look, I seen some brothers on the streets, man. They said we the Israelites. And some things we can't do. You see what I'm saying? And he going to show you real fast that you shouldn't be in there no more.
Yep.
All right. He might get mad.
Yep.
All right. He might tell you never come back and talk to us again.
Yep.
Right. He might say we are the devil.
Yep.
All right. But we showed you these things out the Bible. So these things are an abomination unto God. How does God feel about abominations? Read this.
The book of Sirach, chapter 15, verse 13.
Yeah.
The Lord hateth all abominations.
What did the Lord say?
The Lord hateth all abominations.
Did you know God hate? Abominations. Yeah, he hate abominations, right? So eating shrimp, crab, and lobster, and pork is an abomination to God. Uh-huh. Would you want to be in the midst of doing something and participating in things that God hates? No, and you want to be on the Lord's good side, man. You don't want to be on the bad hand of the Lord, man. All right, and it's dreadful to fall in the hands of the living God, man. Right? Bring this out. Give me Leviticus 19 and 17.
Con.
Book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 17.
No,
thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
Here's another commandment. It's the main commandment that we break. The Lord said we're not supposed to hate our brother, right? In our heart. Who's your brother? Us, people of your own people, right? So what you gotta do with your brother? If you can't hate him, you gotta what? You gotta love him. All right, go ahead.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
And you're supposed to correct your neighbor. Who's your neighbor? Your brothers, yeah. Go ahead.
And not suffer sin upon him.
And what?
And not suffer sin upon him.
So not suffer sin upon him. So next time, you know, they got the damn pork chops, you know what I mean, in the damn grease, right? Next time they got the shrimp boiling up, hey, you got to kind of say, hey, man, I read this. We can't eat that. That's an abomination. Don't you know God hate that? Hey, that's love. So you gotta correct them, right? Because now you know something they don't know. Go ahead.
Thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudge.
And you can't have grudges, read.
Against the children of thy people.
Against the white man.
Against the children of thy people.
Against all people.
Against the children of thy people.
Against the children of what people? Your own people, the children of thy people. Meaning what? We gotta forgive each other. If I do you wrong, you gotta forgive me. You can't be like, I'm gonna get this nigga back, man. F this nigga. I ain't effing with this nigga no more, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, that's right. That's right. But now we know it's talking about each other. Right? Go ahead.
But thou shalt love.
Because we don't got no problem forgiving white people, right? We automatically love and forgive them, right? Go ahead.
But thou shalt love thy neighbor.
Thy what?
Thy neighbor. As thyself.
So pastor teach you that, right? He said, now go tell pastor your neighbor is who?
The white man. Thyself.
Read again.
God.
You gotta stay with us, brother. You kinda, you know what I'm saying?
I'm tired.
Go ahead.
Verse 18. Leviticus chapter 19, verse 18. Thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people.
What people is God talking about? Thy people, right? And what did he say after that?
But thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
So who is your neighbor? The children of thy people, right? All right. All right, brother. So what's your nationality?
I'm Dominican, black, Indian. Look, that's what
the world taught you that.
Yeah.
What God taught you.
Somebody got to fly. Who got the fly? Zo!
Oh, you got fly.
All right, brother. What do we do to get in this situation?
In this situation we're in now?
Yeah.
To the rules.
What do we do? How do we get into slavery?
Now listen to the rule of God.
Yeah, and what do we do?
What do we do?
Yeah, what do we do against God?
Not listen to the rules.
Not listen to the what?
The rules.
The law.
The law.
Right, yeah. Which are rules, but in the Bible they're known as the law, right? And what do we got to do to get out of this situation?
Listen to
him. Listen to him in what? In what? Give me James 1 and 22. You right, though. You know what I'm saying? There's more to that, though. James 1 and 22.
The book of James chapter 1 and verse 22.
Because you say now we got to listen. Is that enough to just listen to it? Because y'all sit in church all day and listen to pastor.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Don't they sit there and listen to pastor? And he don't talk about none of this we talking about, dude. He talk about a blessing, don't he? You be talking about that blessing, right? How to get that blessing, then he asks for that money, don't he? See if we ask for some money before you go. I see he got the money in his hand. You gonna give us some money? Go ahead.
The book of James 1 and 22.
Uh-huh.
Be ye doers of the word.
What the Lord say?
Be ye doers of the word.
Read.
And not hearers only.
And what?
And not hearers only.
So can we just hear the word? What do we gotta do? You gotta
do it.
You gotta
what?
You gotta do it. You gotta do it.
That's right.
Right? So we broke the commandments and now we gotta what? Do the commandments. Give me Numbers 15 and 38. Got one. Numbers 15, 38.
The book of Numbers, chapter 15 and verse 38.
Right?
Speak unto the children of Israel.
Speak unto who?
Speak unto the children of Israel.
Who are we, brother? Children of Israel. You forgot that. You start talking about damn Dominican and all that. Yeah. We're the Israelites, brother.
That's right.
Right? Where are the Dominicans in the Bible? I'm not in there. Yeah, bro. You're an Israelite, brother. Who are you?
Israel.
What's your nationality?
Israel.
What's your ethnicity?
Israel.
What's your race?
Israel.
Israelite.
All
right, go ahead.
Speak unto the children of Israel.
Now, we talking to you, right?
Yeah.
So the Lord told us, are we doing this? Are we making this up? Is it what the Lord said? He told us to tell you something, right? So this is what he told us to tell you, read.
And bid them.
And what?
And bid them.
And bid them, read.
That they make them fringes.
Make them what?
That they make them fringes.
And they make them fringes, read.
In the borders of their garments.
In the what?
In the borders of their garments.
Do a quick scan. Look at all these brothers' shirts. What's on their shirts? Yeah. Look at all these brothers. These brothers got the fringes. on their garments, on their clothes. Why do we do this? We do it because it look cool. It is kind of fly though. You know what I'm saying?
Because you're listening to God.
That's right. You're listening to God, and we what? Doing what he said. God told us to make fringes in the borders of our garments, read.
Throughout their generation.
For how long?
Throughout their generation.
When Jesus come, we ain't got to do it no more.
Throughout their generation.
Are we still generating? Yeah. Yeah, I see little man right here, right? So we still should be doing it, right? Read.
And that they put upon their fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue.
A what?
A ribbon of blue.
What kind of ribbon do all these brothers got on there? Blue, right? Now the fringe is different colors, but the ribbon is the same color, right? It's blue. Why do we do that?
Because they're listening to the Bible.
Because God said it, right?
That's right.
Go ahead.
And it shall be unto you for a fringe.
It shall be unto you for a fringe, read.
That ye may look upon it.
That me may look upon the fringes.
And remember all the commandments of the Lord.
You forgot. If you had your fringes on, you would have known to not leave that bacon alone. You say, look, let me get some turkey bacon. Right?
Some beef bacon.
Some beef bacon, man. It's still good.
Right.
Go ahead.
And remember all the commandments of the Lord.
Some of the commandments.
All the commandments of the Lord.
And remember the commandments of the Lord that we broke, read.
And do them.
And what?
And do them.
And what?
And do them.
And hear them.
And do them.
And do them. So when you read what God said to do, you actually got to do. It's not something to just read. Just pass the wet fringes. Ask Pastor, where's your fringes? Does he got a beard on his face? He don't? Give me Leviticus 21 and 5.
Book of Leviticus chapter 21 verse 5.
Bring it out.
They shall not make baldness upon their head.
He bald headed?
No, he didn't be.
Go ahead.
Neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard.
Neither what?
Neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard.
According to the Bible, should we shave off our beard? No. So is pastor, does pastor follow the Bible? So what is he up there to do? He up there to get that money. You see what I'm saying? They pass that little thing around, don't they? See that, man? Right? Go ahead.
Nor make any cuttings in their flesh.
Give me Leviticus 19, 28. You got tattoos?
I got it, bro.
Yeah? How many you got?
Three.
Three of them? All right, so let's read something real quick.
God.
I do too. Yeah, yeah. All right. You think God okay with that? Read that.
My grandmother didn't want me to get them either. She, like,
she didn't let you get them either?
She didn't want me to.
Right. Well, she was right about that. All right, go ahead.
Book of Leviticus chapter 19, verse 28.
Bring it up.
Ye shall not make any cuttings in your flesh for the dead, nor print any marks.
Nor what?
Nor print any marks.
Nor what?
Nor print any marks.
Nor print any marks. Read.
Upon you.
Oh, what?
Upon you.
So, I had did this before I knew that. So I had to repent. I had to ask the Lord to forgive me for it. Right? I had to say, Salakia. Right? And I had to confess the sin before the Most High. Then I had to stop getting tattoos. So you got to do the same thing and you can't get no more tattoos. Why? Because God said don't do it.
Well, Hebrews.
Give me Romans 6 and 23. Yeah.
That's for this verse.
Romans 6 and 23. Yeah. You was thinking about getting another one? Getting some more?
Yeah.
You still thinking about it? Now you know it's a sin, right?
Yeah.
It's a sin. For the Israel. Now the white man, he can get all the tattoos he want. Right? You was gonna end up looking like Lil Wayne?
Oh, no.
You was gonna get something on your face?
I was never gonna do that.
All right, go ahead.
The book of Romans, chapter 6 and verse 23.
That man got down. That man just down like his little girl just started writing on his face. He ain't wash it off. Go ahead. Go ahead.
6 and 23. For the wages of sin is death.
What the Lord say?
For the wages of sin is death.
What is a wage? You got a job? What is a wage?
You get paid?
Yeah, that's what you get paid. The Lord said there's a payment for sinning. So the Lord said, read it.
For the wages of sin.
For the payment for sin, read.
Is death.
It is what?
Is death.
Why do people die? That's the wage and the payment for what? For sinning. See what I'm saying? How do you live?
By not doing the sins.
That what? Give me Proverbs 7:2.
There you go.
Hey, you smart, man.
All
right. Is it hard? No. Give me Ecclesiastes 12 and 13. It's not that hard, right? Is it hard not to get a tattoo? So why the Christian church say, when you throw away the law, you just believe on Jesus? Because they like that damn pork. Right? But you got to stop doing that. You got to follow God. Read that.
Kind of book of Proverbs chapter 72. Yeah. Keep my commandments.
Do what?
Keep my commandments.
Keep the what? And what?
And live.
And what?
And live.
The wages of sin is what? The wages of sin is what?
Wages.
Debt. You sin, you what? You die. How do you live? Read that.
Keep my commandments and live.
Do what?
Keep my commandments and live.
Give me John 14 and 6. Keep my commandments and live. Right? Who's coming to bring us life? Everlasting life. The Lord, right? Who is he coming to give that to?
The ones who don't sin.
The ones who don't sin.
All right.
14 and 6. John 14 and 6.
The book of John, chapter 14 and verse 6.
Yeah.
And Jesus said unto him.
Who?
And then Jesus said unto him.
Who's talking? Read.
I am the way.
Uh-huh.
The truth.
Uh-huh.
And the life.
The what?
And the life.
He's the truth, the way, and the life. Read.
No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
So how do you get the kingdom of heaven?
By sinning.
And how?
Listening to his commandments that he gave.
Right. Right. So you get the kingdom of heaven by repenting from your sins. You got to confess your sins with your mouth. All right, you got to ask the Lord for forgiveness. Then you got to what? Stop doing it. Then you got to learn the things that he said we're supposed to be doing and start to do it, like keeping the Sabbath day.
Done.
Now you can start there, right? Give me Zephaniah 2 and 1. Zephaniah 2 and 1.
I got it. The book of Zephaniah. Chapter 2 and verse 1.
Yeah.
Gather yourselves together.
What the Lord say?
Gather yourselves together.
Read.
Yea, gather together, O nation, not the desire.
It's another commandment. The Lord told us to gather together. O nation, that's not desire. All right, we don't want to gather together. We want to gather together to people that don't even like you. You see what I'm saying? So the Lord said he wanted his children to gather together, man, as the Israelites. So you got to gather with your own brothers, with like-minded individuals. Give me Psalms chapter 1 and verse 1. Read this.
Book of Ecclesiastes.
Like, what is our purpose in life? You know, pastor always saying, you guys got a purpose. Yeah, but they tell you, you're going to be a singer, you're going to blow up. Yeah. That's what they be telling you? He told you that was your purpose, right? Yeah. For God. Did he show you in the Bible? Or he just told you? He just said it, right? Because I you know what I'm saying? I do music too. And the pastor told me that too. I believe. He said, the Lord told me. You know what I'm saying? And I realized the Lord didn't tell, when the Lord tells somebody something and it don't happen? You see what I'm saying?
Book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12, verse 13.
Pray up.
Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter.
Here's the conclusion of the whole matter. Out of everything we just said, out of all these words in the Bible, there's a conclusion. Go ahead.
Fear God.
Do what?
Fear God.
At the end of the day, you got to learn to fear God. Go ahead.
And keep his commandments.
And what?
And keep his commandments.
What's the whole point of the whole life?
To listen to God's commandments.
And keep his commandments, right? Read.
For this is the whole duty of man.
For what?
For this is the whole duty of man.
What's the whole duty of, why did God create you?
To follow what he says.
To keep the commandments. Playing upon tables, right? Is that hard? What's your nationality? All right, brother. God damn. All praise to the Most High, man. How you get the kingdom of heaven?
It's about following God's laws.
That's right. What can you eat? What can you eat out of the waters?
Fish, salmon, not
You gotta have what?
Scales and
fins. Fins and scales. That's right. That's right. That's right. What about shrimp, crab, and lobster?
Can't eat that.
Okay. What about crawfish? What about catfish?
I don't have
it don't got fins and scales. Alright, it got fins, but it don't got scales. Alright, brother. So you live around here?
Yeah, I live like 20 minutes away.
Alright, man, well, we out here every week, man. We got a fly right here, man. We got a YouTube channel on there.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? We got an email on there if you got questions, man.
Alright.
But you know what I mean? We living in the last days. But, quickly and speedily. Give me that in
Chirac.
Yeah, 5 and 7. Before you go.
The book of Chirac, chapter 5 and verse 7.
Uh-huh.
Slide. Make no tarrying to turn to the Lord.
Right, like don't, tarrying means to drag your feet and take your time.
Right.
Yeah. All right, don't walk away from here and kind of, well, everything we said, go through one end out the other. You kind of get back in life and going about your day, and then you forget about it. You end up getting that tattoo, get with your friends, get high and mess around and got another tattoo. Yeah. Right? Don't tarry. Go ahead.
And put not off from day to day.
Don't put off from day to day. Don't be like, you know what, I'm going to eat this last piece of bacon, and then next week I'm going to stop.
Done.
You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
For suddenly.
For what?
For suddenly.
For suddenly, meaning out of nowhere, read.
Shall the wrath of the Most High come forth.
Because God can judge you at any moment, at any second. The Lord don't got to wait till Jesus come to judge you.
Done.
The Lord can judge you. People die every day.
Done.
And you don't know why. Right? Go ahead.
And in thy security.
And in your security. Right? Like today, you was kind of in your security. Right? I mean, you out here chilling. You got the clean, all blue Nike suit on with little bro. Kind of doing your thing. You know what I'm saying? Something could kind of happen to you, man. Yeah. Or when you at the crib, right? Hey, it was a dude in Dallas, man, Dallas, Texas, man. So-called black man. The police came in and shot him while he's eating ice cream.
Yep.
What more security are you with your shirt off on the couch eating ice cream with your door closed? He was secure. That's in your security when you think nothing's going to happen. Somebody just came out of nowhere and put him to death. So in your security, read.
And in thy security, thou shalt be destroyed.
Thou shalt what?
Thou shalt be destroyed.
Thou shalt be destroyed. Give me Sirach 21 and 1.
Revenge?
Yeah.
Give me and perish in the day of vengeance.
And perish in the day of vengeance. So instead of being delivered and saved, in that day, the Lord going to make you destroy you.
Fine.
All right. Read this. Sirach 21 and 1. 17:24.
24.
Book of Sirach, chapter 17, verse 24.
Bring it up.
Last two. Go ahead.
But unto them that repent.
Unto them that repent, like you, brother, Rick.
He granted them return.
The Lord allow you to return. Go ahead.
And comforted those that failed in patience.
Go ahead.
Return unto the Lord.
Rick.
And forsake thy sins.
And do what?
And forsake thy sins.
And forsake your sins. Rick.
Make thy prayer before his face.
Do what?
Make thy prayer before his face.
Uh-huh.
And offend less.
And what?
And offend less.
And offend less. Bring this out. Give me Sirach 21 and 1.
Book of Sirach, chapter 21 from the top.
Go ahead.
My son, hast thou sinned?
Have you sinned? Yep, read.
Do so no more.
What the Lord say?
Do so no more.
It's that simple. Just stop doing it. Read.
But ask pardon for thy former sins.
Ask pardon for your former sins. Ask for forgiveness. Go ahead.
Flee from sin.
Flee from, run away from sin. Go ahead.
As from the face of a serpent.
Just like you saw a snake, you'll get the hell out the way. Go ahead.
For if thou comest too near it, it will bite thee.
That's the teeth of sin. It'll bite you and get you killed. Go ahead.
The teeth thereof are as the teeth of a lion.
The teeth thereof are as the teeth of a lion. All right, brother. So you're an Israelite, you got to keep the commandments, man. It's a lot to learn, man. So check that flyer out, man, and you be safe, bro. All right?
All right, King. All right, King.
All right, man.
What was your name again?
Keyshawn.
Keyshawn. All right, King.
Con. Give me the book of Hosea, chapter 1, verse 10. Hosea 1 and 10. That's all I want, brother.
King.
The book of Hosea, chapter 1 and verse 10.
Bring it out.
Yet the number of the children of Israel shall be as the sand of the sea,
right,
which cannot be measured nor numbered. And it shall come to pass that in that place where it is, where it was said unto them, ye are not my people, there it shall be said unto them, ye are the sons of the living God.
Yo, what?
Ye are the sons of the living God.
So that's what we out here to do. Hey, the Lord said, in America, we're going to tell our people they're the sons of the living God, man. Hey, that brother learned that today, man.
Uh-huh.
So all praises to the Most High.